The Philadelphia Eagles visit the Meadowlands with their 2-1 record against the New York Giants with their 0-3 record. And they'll be led by a new quarterback today, Randy Dean. The stadium, as always, is sold out. There is Dean the Scrambler, the athlete. Absolutely perfect day for Giant Stadium. And we welcome you to our broadcast this afternoon. I'm Pat Summerall. And this, of course, is Tom Brookshier. The Eagles-Giants, I can remember when we used to not like each other.
Yeah, a lot. The Giants are a lot like Rodney Dangerfield. They can't get any respect. Even though it's a home game, they were booed coming on. And they won the toss and will receive the football. But the Eagles have been allowing like 93 or 4 yards rushing per mm-hmm. game. It looks to me like Randy Dean is stepping into perhaps the world's toughest position as quarterback.
I would think so. Joe Pisarcik is just, they say, too beaten up to continue, and he has taken a tremendous beating in the 3 games so far. Let's go down to the action and time on the field. The coaches, Ray Perkins for the Giants on the left in the blue, and Dick Vermeil of the Eagles. His team with a record of 2-1, thinking about playoffs. The game officials today will be led by the referee, Jerry Seaman, and the rest of his group. You can see. What a day. Not a cloud anywhere. Bright sunshine at Giant Stadium.
And young Franklin is going to be kicking off. That's Tony Green waiting for it.
Tony Green is number 34. And watch this guy kick if you haven't seen him. Barefooted. You have to wear a stocking in the NFL. But you don't have to wear a shoe.
He also is a bachelor, and he's said to have the sexiest foot perhaps in all of football. That's the word that he's trying to get out. I think he's quite a character.
I asked him before the game we were talking, I asked him how he liked Philadelphia. He said, I found out you can't wear it out. He is a talent, no question about that. We saw him in the Sun Bowl when he was at Texas A&M. Ripped one from about 65 yards out. And longer than that in practice. So the Eagles and the Giants in their second meeting of the year. It will be Tony Green at the 2. Straight up the middle comes Tony. Boxed around at about the 24, and the Giants will have possession at that point. John Spagnola made the tackle.
Here it is. It might look like a Mayo Clinic diary, right? Coppins, the just received from L.A. before the second league game, was at left tackle. Simmons is in place of Van Horn. Clack is always at center. J.T. Turner still alive at right guard. And Gordon Gravel, number 71, is at right tackle. I guarantee you we'll check his name very closely.
That is a correct number for Gordon.
I promise.
The rest of the Giant offensive unit. And Randy Dean, the quarterback, as Gary Shirk, the tight end, changes sides. Doug Porter cuts back in the middle for 2 or 3. Not much more. The Eagle defense throughout most of the day will be a 3-4. 3 front, 4 linebackers. And here is that defense.
Here's Claude Humphrey making a big comeback, the great Atlanta Falcon. Charlie Johnson, a 265-pound nose guard. And Carl Harrison, who is no longer underrated. He could be the All-Pro this year.
Flag down on that first play. And the discussion continues as you look at the rest of the Eagle defense.
You never replace Bill Berge, a 240-pounder, an 11-year great All-Pro the last 5 or 6. But Terry Totola is in there at that inside linebacking spot.
There was no illegal shift on the call.
How's that? There was a flag, but there was nothing wrong.
They must have thought about an illegal shift. Bobby Howard, that the Giants will probably work on, number 23. Herm Edwards, the man of the magnificent fumble return, and your safety men, of course, are Bernard Wilson and Randy Logan.
3-yard pickup by Doug Coder. So it's 2nd and 7. No penalty. Randy Dean gives again to Coder. Few more yards this time. Claude Humphrey, the aforementioned, made the stop. Humphrey, the All-Pro at Atlanta. Now let's look at that Eagle defense again.
This is Marion Campbell's defense. It's a stacked 34. Sometimes even the defensive ends, like Harrison, will be off the man that they're playing over, the tackle. And somehow they react and read, and they're a very aggressive defensive team. They have 13 sacks coming in just 3 games.
About 4 yards needed for the Giant first down. Line of scrimmage, their own 32. Randy Dean's first pass attempt is complete. Henry Moorhead breaks the tackle, and he should have enough for the first down. Frank Lamaster finally took him out of bounds.
Now, Reggie Wilkes, number 51, has been moved from the right linebacking spot to the left because John Bunning is out with a double virus and a pull muscle. Watch number 51. He's been playing right extremely well. Now he misses the tackle. The master has to cover for him.
9-yard pickup. Minnesota Green Bay is a final. The Vikings 27, Green Bay 21. Final score. That was in overtime.
Young Dean is an extremely poised, cool young person, isn't he?
He is a fine athlete. He fakes the cutter and fires. Intended for Jimmy Robinson off his fingertips. Covered by Herman Edwards.
Right, give. There's Perkins and the giant bench. You can see the offensive signals being relayed against the sun. I guess they know what's being received out there.
Ray Perkins with one of the headsets on. Pat Hoxson is the other giant assistant. There's Perkins in the middle. Randy Dean, now 1-for-2. Giants second and 10 at their own 42. Their record 0-3. The Eagles 2-1 as Dean runs the draw play to Doug Coter. Claude Humphrey again leads the Eagle defense. That is a final score now. It's Baltimore led early. Pittsburgh 17-13 to remain unbeaten. Bradshaw was hurt but came back to throw the touchdown pass that won it.
And about 9 other Steelers were hurt. They sat out some people and still won. By the way, Doug Coter was the last Giant to have a 100-yard-plus rushing day. A year ago, he had, I think, 118 against St. Louis. But I'll tell you, this is a tough group to run against for a steady diet.
Gary Shirk is out at tight end for the Giants, and Al Dixon, number 84, is in.
Third and long.
Seven, in fact. Humphrey puts the heat on. The flag goes down, and what a hit. Moorhead stays on his feet, breaks a couple of tackles. And he took a shot early, but broke right out of it. John Shara finally made the stop. The flag is down, however. He broke the tackle attempt by Frank LeMaster. And we'll listen to the discussion of the officials.
Ran over the tackle by LeMaster.
Against the Giants.
Going to be holy. Boy, Moorhead, of course, has been moved back to the running back spot from the receiving spot. He's 212 pounds, about 6'2.5" tall. Always had the potential to play anywhere. Look at him walk through LeMaster, who's a good tackler, his block. Also Herm Edwards. I think that was Shara finally made a tackle.
Finally did, but they'll bring the whole thing back. That's the final score. The Patriots 27, San Diego 21. And that drops one more team from the unbeaten list. San
Diego. Illegal use of hands. Number 69, offense.
Roy Simmons was the culprit. Dave Jennings loosening up in his cage over on the sideline.
Might be the safest place here. The crowd is a little angry for only the fourth game of the season, huh?
They did not get a very affirmative reception. The Giants didn't when they came out. Third and 17 situation now. Facing Randy Dean, who's having all the plays called for him from the sideline by hand signal. Straight back. And now rolls right and throws and underthrows. I'm not sure who was the intended receiver, but Claude Humphrey was putting on the heat as Randy Dean checks back to the sideline.
Pretty good idea, though, to run the sprint out with a young man that's got the good feet under it and a good athlete. At least try to make the linebackers perhaps leave and uncover somebody. Here's the guy that's leading the NFC in punting. He'll hang it up there, and once in a while he'll fake it and pass it. He did against the St. Louis Cardinals, but
we'll check the hang time as Wally Henry is back deep for the Eagles. Dangerous man. A new snapper for Jennings is Peck. Line drive kick should be returned. He should have some room, too. Henry goes down, and so does a flag go down. A 45-yard punt. A line shot. The man who did the snapping, Eck, is the man who made the tackle.
Looked like there might have been a call on hitting below the waist on a punt return. You can't do it either on the kickoff or the punt. Looked like it might have been Lynn Burnham that was down there just trying to help hit somebody down on the trousers.
Which, of course, is also known as clipping. And they'll walk it off against Philadelphia, where Ron Jaworski will set his offense down from there. Keep in mind, as we watch early in the game. Harold Carmichael, the wide receiver, the big one, has 99 consecutive games in which he's caught a pass. Listen.
Personal foul, clipping, number 67, receiving team.
You were right. Burnham, there he is.
This has been one of the things the officials, though, they said have they have not had to overcall this year. For some reason, the pros know they can't, and it's been pretty well maintained.
That didn't look like it was too bad a block. You cannot block below the waist, but you can't hit him in the back either, I guess. Nothing between the Eagles and the Giants in the first quarter. Pat Summerall of Tom Brookshire at Giants Stadium as Washington leads St. Louis 13-7 in the third quarter. The Redskins had been ahead 13-0. Here's Ron Jaworski on the first possession. Leroy Harris, one of the running backs. Wilbert Montgomery, the dangerous one, the other. It is Montgomery. Hit by Dan Lloyd, who is starting in place of Harry Carson, by the way. Here's the Eagle offense.
Stan Walters, an all-pro left tackle. Petey Payro, a young rookie, a number two draft choice in there, a big kid at 260. Guy Morris, Woody Peoples, Jerry Sizemore, and a tight end named Keith Prepley, who is very, very good.
And the rest of the group, including Big Harold Carmichael and Charles Smith, the wide receivers, and the two running backs we just mentioned. Montgomery got three on first down. It'll be second and seven. It is Montgomery again as he cuts back against the grain and gets about three or four more. Jeff Weston, a new starter, a rookie, starting for the Giants on defense in place of John Mendenhall, who's out. There's the Giant bench.
Mendenhall is out, and also Harry Carson. And when Wilbert Montgomery found out that Carson wasn't going to play the middle linebacker, everybody stood and cheered because he's considered the hardest tackler, perhaps playing the MLB spot in the National Football League.
Third and three coming up. Jaworski straight back, throwing for Carmichael. If he's in bounds, that is game number 100, in which he's caught a pass.
Last time Harold was shut out was by the Giants in 1972. And that does seem a long time ago, even for an old guy like me. Here's Jaworski, the rifle, who is throwing very much under control this year, right on. And Harold leans 6'8" right out of bounds.
Terry Jackson, the defender. Here's another final score. Detroit, 24. Atlanta, 23.
30. That's a 55-yard run by Haskell Standback for the margin.
Now it's for Atlanta to make it close, but Detroit the winner. A happy Monty Clark, I'd imagine. There's Leroy Harris, swarmed on just as soon as he got the ball. The charge led for the Giants by Brian Kelly.
Brian Kelly is playing the middle linebacker spot along with Lloyd. Once in a while, they'll bring Kelly into the middle, number 55, who is smaller. Lloyd, 54, certainly no Harry Carson, though. And that time, the misdirection play by the Eagles, they thought everybody might be chasing Wilbert Montgomery. Big Doug Van Horn, who's on the sidelines. He doesn't like that, the big left guard.
He's had a variety of physical ailments. Second and nine for Philadelphia. Line of scrimmage, their own 27. Jaworski moves his backs. First quarter action at Giant Stadium. Giants fake a blitz, don't come. Flags go down again as Montgomery takes the handoff.
Looks like young Petey Payro may have jumped a little bit early, number 62.
How about this score? Buffalo 46, the New York Jets 31.
Todd hit through a 27-yard TD pass to Mickey Schuler to get the Jets back in it. And it's hard to believe they were in it, but they were in that game for a while, weren't they?
That rookie receiver, you look at the Giant get-together on the sideline. A rookie receiver for Buffalo, Jerry Butler, caught four touchdown passes, 10 receptions on the day, for a total of 255 yards.
Left tackle, offense.
Stan Walters instead of Petey Payro. The rookie didn't do it.
Those statistics on that...
Five TD passes?
Four. Those stats on Butler in the Buffalo game, and that is an all-time NFL record for yards gained pass receiving.
There's Wilbert slipping off the right side. People that watched the Eagle practice all week said he ran more quickly this week than ever before. Watch Woody Peoples, the left part of your screen. Take the defensive tackle, break him down, make him spin to get out of there. And Wilbert, who had, of course, over 1,200 last year, is still having a great year. He came in number five in the division at 4.5 yards a shot.
Kansas City, Oakland, surprising score. The Chiefs 21, Oakland nothing. Third and six at Giants Stadium, as Ron Jaworski has one lone setback. And he gives to him. Montgomery trying to get the bounce. The scramble is for it. The Giants pick it up. It is Ray Rhodes. Touchdown, Giants.
Talk about standing up and hollering. Look at this. Now, any running back knows once you've committed the problem, the Cardinals sent a fumbling. He did it with his left thigh guard. Wilbert Montgomery should have fallen on the ball. He kept trying to pick it up. Watch Rhodes. The former receiver comes right through, scoots it up, and get ready to line up for the extra point. They may be calling this back, though. The flag is down.
They probably will say it was a lateral, and a lateral cannot be advanced by the defensive team. I imagine that's going to be the call.
Only possession gain, but not advancing, huh?
Right. Montgomery really never had possession.
Dick Vermeil all week was worried about a team like the Giants being embarrassed and scoring early and making a contest early against a team that they think might be better.
Boos from the crowd you can hear right now because they think it should be a Giant touchdown. We'll get the call, and apparently we're not going to get the call. It is Giants ball. It'll be first and 10 for them at the 21-yard line.
You go right upstairs and throw it, don't you, if you're young Randy Dean?
You certainly think about it. Ernest Gray starts in motion. Moorhead swings to the outside. Fumble. It still belongs to the Giants. Jerry Robinson made the tackle.
Off the left side, right at Carl Hairston, the defensive end on the 30. Linebacker made good penetration to Tola. Actually, Robinson got in there, and it looked like LeMaster may have had part of the ball, but he didn't get it.
Giants still have it. It'll be second and six at about the Eagle 18. No scores yet. Coder. Good yardage and a good hole as Doug Coder cuts back inside. Good blocking. Carl Harrison made the stop for the Eagles, 7 yards for Coder.
Good block by Jim Clack, the offensive center. Looks like they're doing a pretty good job against a defense that has allowed absolutely nothing. Look at the cross blocking. JT Turner gets through the hole. Clack and company, along with Moorhead, blow him out of there, and that's a darn good second down run against that defense.
It'll make it third and one as Neville replaces Gravel on the right side of the Giants offensive line. Randy Dean, the quarterback, gives again to Coda. May have a first. Very close. Harry Totolo made the tackle.
Randy Dean's about 6'2", 195, and carries almost a 7-yard rushing average himself. So don't be surprised if sometime he naked bootlegs it and runs a little bit. That would be a new part of the Giant offense, wouldn't it?
It is a Giant first down at the moment. Randy Dean is from Northwestern, and many times in practice he works out as a wide receiver. And they say he does very well.
They say he doesn't throw the long ball too well, but a lot of short passes add up to a lot of big arm strength, don't they?
Sure do. First down, Giants, just outside the 10. Moorhead starts to cut back, gets inside the 10, but not much more than that. Jerry Robinson again led the Eagle tacklers. So it'll be second down, Giants. At the 9 is where they put it.
Good
no
rush,
score.
Good rushing game, and this is the Eagle defense that let the Saints, the high-powered Saints, only get off 49 plays a week ago, and the Giants are going right at their strength saying, all right, we're all hurt up front. We don't have any tackles, right? We're going to run it at you anyway and see what happens, and they're doing it.
Make it second and 9. They can make a first down without scoring a touchdown. Draw play to Moorhead, who's near the five. Stopped again by Carl Hairston. This telecast is presented by authority of the National Football League. It's intended for the private use of our audience. Any rebroadcast or other use of this telecast without the express written consent of the Giants and the National Football League is prohibited.
That fumble by the Eagles, by Wilbert Montgomery, was the ninth fumble the Eagles have had, and only the third one they've lost. There's Harry Carson, the missing middle linebacker.
Third and four. At the Eagle five, Randy Dean, the Giant quarterback. Goes in the direction of Robinson and throws it out of the end zone and over his head. Well covered by Herman Edwards.
Joe Donnello's coming on the field. He is only 1 for 3. Young Dean, that time again, that is inexperienced. And as somebody said, you can't rush inexperience. The only way you can get it is to play it out.
We saw a good-looking young quarterback last week in the person of Vince Evans for the Chicago Bears, who in a situation like that scored on a quarterback draw. Dean stays in the game to hold for Joe Donnello. Shot will come from 22 yards away from the goalpost.
Good kicker.
Successful. 3-0 Giants. 6:29 left to play in the first quarter at Giants Stadium. And the Giants take the lead over the Eagles by the score of 3-0. The Giants, 3. That's the story of their scoring drive. So the Eagles, nothing. And Joe Donnello about ready to kick off to perhaps Wally Henry, number 89.
He's number one in the NFL. He's got a 30-point average. Good kick.
Sails back into the end zone, and Henry's going to bring it out. He had some second thoughts.
Oh.
And perhaps he should have. He does not get back to the 20-yard line. Good kick.
You might recall how the first Giant-Eagle game started, the first game of the year, too, that they had this, the Giants settled for a field goal in that one. Here's Lloyd down, playing middle linebacker and still on the kamikaze squads. Boy, they really hit Wally Henry. Bam.
He is good on special teams. New Orleans and San Francisco, the 49ers lead the Saints 7-0 in the first quarter. John Mendenhall, the veteran Giant middle guard or defensive tackle, depending upon whatever setup they're in, resting today so far.
He's got an aching back.
Here's the handoff to Leroy Harris, stopped by Brian Kelly after a few, not many. There's Lloyd again, number 54.
Harry Carson, you've seen on the sidelines. He's got a bad virus. Here's Lloyd getting rid of Morris, the offensive center, and getting in on the tackle, but the yardage was made. Again, if you're going to key Wilbert Montgomery, the Eagles hope to get their new fullback into your secondary for 75 yards or so.
He's dropped a little weight, hasn't he?
About 15 pounds under Vermeil.
I can understand that. Here is Montgomery. Breaks out of the pack the moment Brian Kelly and Beasley Reese finally get him down. Not enough for a first. Looks like it'll be about three that they need to pick up one.
Good play by Gary Jeter and Brian Kelly. They really stopped Wilbert. And Wilbert's a little bit like Walter Payton in that he can bounce out and really go on the long runs when you think you stop. Watch the right part of your screen. Stacked up right at the point there. Jeter does a good job. Backs in. Now you can see Brian Kelly finishing off the tackle.
Just a little bit like Walter Payton would still be better than most folks. Third and three for the Eagles. Lloyd steps up to fill in the middle. Try. And Wilbert Montgomery did just exactly what you described. Bounced off a tackler and got enough, I believe, for an Eagle first down.
He's short enough at about 5'10 to pull that helmet down and get under the bigger fellas. That time, Perot, the rookie left guard, got a good block on Tabor, the big rookie from Oklahoma. And Wilbert, if you can get a standoff, he'll usually take care of 4 or 5 yards. That's a first.
Big game going on down in Tampa, Florida today between the Buccaneers, who are unbeaten, and the Los Angeles Rams. The first quarter score from there is nothing-nothing. You can't get a ticket anywhere for that one.
In the whole state of Florida, right?
Just about. First and 10, Eagle ball at their own 30. Giants lead 3-0 as Jaworski drops. Throws out to Montgomery. That was a lateral. Montgomery manages to hang on and does not quite get back to the line of scrimmage. Brad Van Pelt out there with him.
A great defensive play by Van Pelt. Again, as soon as Jaworski went back, and Ron once in a while looks to his hot receiver a little too much. As soon as he saw they recovered, he dumps it. Good play, but a great tackle. Great tackle.
4-yard loss. Watch Jeff Weston. 73.
Weston going against Woody Peoples, Sizemore. Protection was there. The coverage was excellent by that giant secondary downfield.
So make it 2nd and 14 as the giant defense converges quite nicely. Jaworski goes back. Protection again is good. And now he throws out to Leroy Harris. And again, Brad Van Pelt is close by and herds him out of bounds.
Excellent coverage. You can see Rhodes, number 22, shaking his head. That giant secondary has been about the only unit that Perkins has had that's been solid the whole time. That time they played the fullback on the flare pattern, on the safety pattern well. And again, Van Pelt made the tee.
1-yard pickup will make it 3rd and 13. And you talk about your hot receiver, you'd have to look to Carmichael, wouldn't you?
Even against double coverage, it's good for an interference call occasionally.
Here comes Van Pelt out to cut off the inside route. Ray Rhodes will be deep. He looks the other way. Scott Fitzke is number 81 for Philadelphia, and Terry Jackson on the coverage. He threw away from the double on Carmichael.
A lot of heat by George Martin, too. It will be not considered a sack, but Jaworski did not have time to really plant it and keep the ball in bounds. Good rush by the defensive left end.
The Eagle punter is Max Runiger.
And the Giants blocked the very first punt this young man had in his pro career. Let's see if they try to come.
That's part of the reason his average is not that good. A low snap, but a good kick and a good effort by Runiger. Tommy Green with the fair catch signal. Hang time 4.1, you saw. That's not bad. 43-yard kick.
And the fifth fair catch by Tony Green.
So now, with 3 minutes and 6 seconds left to play in the first quarter at Giant Stadium, the hosts lead 3-0. Monday night on CBS, an outstanding lineup. The White Shadow.
With Big Ken Howard, huh, our friend?
Charges of racism threatening Coach Reeves, Ken Howard.
Don't believe it.
And on MASH, Hot Lips, perhaps he's a spy. And the rest of the lineup is a spectacular one on CBS. Monday night, Randy Dean gets to Doug Coder straight ahead from the I formation. On the Eagle bench, a little homework.
It's Billy Joe, the offensive backfield man, talking to some people about how they're going to change things up.
The Rams have taken a lead over the unbeaten Buccaneers. Jim Youngblood scored on a 31-yard pass interception. The last time Jim was involved with the Buccaneers, Tampa Bay came out with a quarterback with a broken jaw.
That's right. What's the right tackle now? May have been
offside.
Turner. JT looked like
68.
Yeah, JT Turner coming a little early. Remember, these Giants had 4 offensive penalties on Monday night against the Redskins. This was the continuation of that battle. Turner got his man to Tola, but he did it too early.
Gordon Gravel with a good block, 1st and 15. A sweep to Coder. A 6-yard effort. Bobby Howard led the Eagle tacklers, but a good gain nevertheless.
Again, the flanker came back and did a good job on Logan. And there's the Logan coming up to force it. Coder just keeps steaming through there, and Humphrey couldn't get a hold of him. And Reggie Wilkes is having a little trouble tackling at that new left linebacking spot.
Miami leading the Chicago Bears. 3-0, first quarter score, that is. Von Schumann with a field goal.
That's Kenny Iman, the old Green Bay Packer, Los Angeles Ram, who's working with Dick Vermeil, huh?
2nd about 9, fake draw, and Dean's in trouble. Tries to break away and does manage to struggle for perhaps a yard before he goes down in the grasp of Carl Hairston and Jerry Robinson. Ball carried by Dean. Sore pinky. By Robinson.
Slater, I think the offensive snapper,
right,
that had that low snap a little bit for Renegar the last time.
It'll be third and eight for the Giant offensive unit, led today for the first time this year by Randy Dean.
I want to see him throw that ball a little bit. You know, he's got a good delivery.
Overthrown, intended for Doug Coder, but nowhere near.
And not too good a delivery that time. The young man, a little bit, when you get the legs moving on a tee shot and sort of fly at the ball, he overthrew it a little bit, just hung it up. And here will be the busy man for the Giants this season, at least for a while.
Dave Jennings has punted one time today so far. That one was 45 yards. Another guy who's a good athlete, not just a kicker.
Hey, he threw a good pass against St. Louis.
Oh, it's blocked. The Eagles will have possession near midfield. Blocked by John Shira, I believe, number 21.
Shira got it. He's the UCLA former captain for Vermeil out there with those teams. Does everything pretty well. Gets his right hand up on it. First block of the year of a punt by of Jennings' block.
A minute 22 left to play in the first quarter.
Tony Galbraith, a one-yard run for New Orleans. 7-6 San Francisco.
First and 10, Philadelphia. After a partial block of a Dave Jennings punt by John Shira, and Jaworski is going to go for the bunch. As Montgomery, he's going to get the bunch. Brian Kelly was isolated on Wilbert Montgomery. They got the coverage they wanted, and they made it work. 53-yard touchdown pass from Ron Jaworski to Wilbert Montgomery.
Walked right up to the linebacker and stepped around. He had a 26-yard TD reception against New Orleans. And this one was for a bunch. Watch Lloyd down the middle linebacker. Let's see where he goes. 31 is already on his way. He's cut inside and back out. He's just gotten behind. It's Brian Kelly chasing. It's going to be all over. The sixth reception and the second touchdown catch. That's tough when that rusher comes right at the linebacker, though, and makes a swerve.
Perfect throw from Ron Jaworski, too. Here's Tony Franklin with Shira holding. He might kick it all the way out of the stadium. Flag is down as the extra point by Franklin was good, but he might have to do it again.
Well, that linebacker sets up to try to tackle a great ground gainer like Wilbert Montgomery, and all of a sudden he swerves right around him and goes upfield.
The extra point is good.
Extra
defense,
point.
Number 31, offside, to be assessed on the kickoff.
So Franklin will have a chance to kick off from the 40, like we used to.
What did Franklin come to you and say, Mr. Summerall, sir, can you give me some kicking tips?
That's what he asked me.
What'd you say to him?
Well, what is he, 6 out of 6?
6 for 6.
I said, what can I tell you?
Yeah.
Let's take a hot pan right here.
Over on the Eagle bench, the enthusiasm has rekindled itself. The Eagles have captured the lead.
Of course,
Charlie Johnson.
The big lift, though, of course, had to be when the Giants had to settle for a Donello field goal instead of a touchdown when they got close.
There's the barefooted young man. He came out before the game with a shoe on the other foot. And I said, that's going to hurt your image. Can't be having a shoe on.
Did you hear what he's done to Texas football? That every kid down there's they've got a one-footed, barefooted kicker on everybody's team then.
They make him wear that shoe. They're afraid he's going to step on something and hurt that bare foot. It ought to be as tough as anywhere else. From the 40, and if he hits it, it'll be all the way out of the end zone. He got it too high. That is Billy Taylor for the Giants, swinging around to the outside and swinging out of bounds. In the grasp again of John Shira. Next week, the regional games, Minnesota-Detroit. The Giants will be at New Orleans, and so will we. Washington at Atlanta. Tampa Bay against Chicago, St. Louis at Los Angeles, and San Francisco against San Diego.
Tampa Bay. How about Tampa Bay against Chicago? That one time we wouldn't have thought that was much of a game. Now it's a big game.
The Bears have lost just once, and so far Tampa Bay hasn't lost at all. Not yet. First and 10 Giants as Doug Coder breaks into the Eagles secondary momentarily. Frank LeMaster around his feet made the tackle.
We said you can substitute a good player, and Totola is a good pro, a fourth-year man out of UCLA, but he's no Bill Burgie. Burgie at 240 pounds could get the deep drops. He was 20 yards from the line of scrimmage on interceptions, and it looks like the Giants might be running right at this young linebacker in his first real test as a starter.
Seattle 10, Denver nothing. How'd that happen?
Durnick used to play here with the Giants, a five-yard touchdown run for Seattle.
Coder got a Giant first down, again just straight ahead, and again Frank LeMaster, number 55, made the tackle.
Boy, what a makeshift offensive line that they're having to run with, too. You realize all the problems they've had up there. Gordon King, their big draft choice, went down with a bad elbow, and from then on it's sort of been rolling downhill with Bill Austin just coming on the scene 2 weeks ago to try to get them shaped up a little bit.
Probably no more plays in the first quarter at Giant Stadium. There's the gun. The Eagles will change ends of the field. Their lead is 7-3, a 53-yard touchdown pass from Jaworski to Montgomery. Kansas City 28, Oakland nothing.
Arnold Morgado, a one-yard run for Mr. Levy. Marv Levy used to coach with the Eagles.
Miami 3, Chicago now 3, as Bob Thomas has kicked the field goal for the Bears to tie it up.
37-yarder.
First and 10 Giants. Here is a rollout by Dean. Cuts to the 40, to the 45. And that's the way he should be utilized.
Might as well do it. The crowd seems to sense that maybe this is a new dimension at quarterback. Of course, they haven't had a chance to really see him. A year ago, he did average almost 7 yards. This is sort of naked. Gets out behind Turner, gets a good block on LeMaster. And this young man gets hit hard by Totola, but he picked up the first down.
11 yards on that scramble by Randy Dean, and that was not really a scramble. That was a plan.
Didn't look like he minded it either.
Coder gets it on first down and bangs up close to midfield. Carl Harrison led the Eagle defense. Philadelphia leads the Giants 7-3, opening moments of the second quarter.
And sometimes when quarterbacks run, they look like Tiny Tim, you know, through the tulips. It's almost like, get me quick before I run for some yardage or something.
That one was in overtime. Cincinnati led one time 24-0.
Tony Frisch kicked a 29-yard field goal. Boy, they came from nowhere to get that one.
Coder has 9 carries for 42 yards so far. It'll be second down and about 7. Coder and Moorhead behind Dean. The Eagle defense looks almost like the Dallas Flex. For Robinson, an overthrown. Down the sideline, Herman Edwards right with him. Good coverage.
Robinson not with the speed, but he has the moves. They might have thought, the Giants might have thought they could slip up on Edwards and run by him. Here's Tampa Bay 7-6. That's Doug Williams, a 15-yard pass to Larry Mucker.
If you haven't seen Doug Williams, the Tampa Bay quarterback, I don't believe there's a better arm in terms of pure strength anywhere in football. He can really rifle it.
Or a better interview than John McKay, the coach, after a win or a loss, huh?
3rd and 7. The Eagles down with a 4-man rush this time. Here they come. After Dean, and Dean is out of it. He'll get the first down and more. To the 40, 35, 33. Randy Logan finally stopped him.
Watch this now. Good blocking against a 4-man rush. And on this kind of a rush, Marion Campbell lets the Eagles just put their ears back and go. You can see Humphrey overruns it. This takes a lot out of a defensive rush. Now the linebackers have got to come up. They've dropped to about 15 or 20 yards, and they hit each other a lot.
19 yards.
From another angle, here it is. Now we're back to live action.
Here is Moorhead trying to get to the outside. Finally chased out of bounds by Herman Edwards, knocked out by number 46. A name that Giant fans will never forget, Herman Edwards, as he picked up that fumble in this stadium last year when it looked like the Eagles had no hope to win at all. They still mumble about it around here.
We'll try to take a look at that nose guard over Jim Clack. That's Charlie Johnson, number 65, and Clack, and see if we can get a replay and show how that nose guard really works on that 34 defense.
Second and five. That last run by Randy Dean is the longest of his career. He's carried three times for 31 yards. He's going to carry again. He's going to hurt his average. Frank LeMaster led the Eagles.
That's the one thing a young quarterback doesn't do. Now watch Charlie Johnson. He has to decide which way he can go. He gets clacked by. The handoff was not made. And that's the one thing the young Dean's got to learn. If he isn't supposed to carry it, throw it up in the stands.
It'll be third and five. Line of scrimmage is the Eagle 28. Philadelphia leads 7-3. And Doug Coder, after being set, moved. And then tried to adjust things and go up and set down as a flanker.
Looked like Dean might have called him on a pass pattern because he turned to him when they left the huddle and said something to Coder.
I noticed that he moved his foot, Dean did, which usually indicates when you drop your heel like he did, that somebody should be starting in motion. Nobody did. And then Coder finally moved.
Of course, the good defense, as soon as that happens, boom, you come right across and
that's
make
right.
contact.
That'll make it third and 10 now.
Illegal motion, number 44, offense.
Ray Perkins.
Somebody said he had the eyes of a gunslinger out in El Paso or somewhere like that. You know, just faces the sun and squints off.
Tough eyes.
Good coach.
Yes, Washington 17, St. Louis 7. Somewhat of a surprise. Here is Dean throwing and having Doug Coder. Not enough for a first down. Frank LeMaster converged with some help from some of his friends.
Not bad. I think that was the play they were going to run on third down and five before the penalty.
If they had run it before the penalty, they'd have a first down. Instead, they're sending in Joe Donnello, who's hit from 22 yards out already. 7-3 Philadelphia.
This time last year, he was 7 of 9 over the 78 season, outside of the 40, and 2 of 3 over 50. He was one of the greatest kickers, I think, in the game a year ago.
This one will be from 42 yards out. Dean holding, Donnello kicking. Shot. Oh, that one almost went into the stands. That would have been good from 55 yards at least. Donnello makes it 7-6. As we have 11 minutes and 4 seconds left to play in the first half at Giant Stadium. Eagles up by one.
Wrong.
Giant Stadium sold out. CBS Sports Spectacular is loaded too with the world's strongest men competition. You're involved in that.
Well, I wasn't one of the strongest men, but I watched them lift some barrels and bend some bars. Bob Young of the Cardinals is there, and John Kolb of Pittsburgh, along with big strong fellas.
What's in the barrel?
Nothing. After we got through with it.
Wally Henry dribbles it around the 4-yard line and then hits back upfield, tries to get to the outside, breaks one tackle, breaks another one, and is finally taken out of bounds by number 51, Frank Marion.
Wally Henry. Looks like he was doomed that time. Got about the 20-yard line and somehow got outside. There's that scoring play, that field goal. And what a strong kick that was by Donnello. He must know that the young guy from Texas is in the stadium today, huh?
Going to give him a little clinic, perhaps.
Do you kickers do that? Do you sort of say, well, the other big kickers in town, like, did you do that with Groza in those days?
Yeah, but he didn't know it. It'll be first and 10 Philadelphia. They lead by one, 7-6. Ron Jaworski, the quarterback, playing with a sore index finger on his passing hand. It didn't show on the touchdown pass, did it? Here's Jaworski out to Carmichael. Quick screen to him. With some room, and Harold Carmichael hopping over people. High stepping for close to an Eagle first down. In fact, he did get enough.
Boy, Rhodes came up the right cornerback, number 22, just in time. to have Stan Walters, a 275-pound offensive tackle, hit him right in the head. Now watch the left part of your screen. Watch the elbow. Boom. Almost knocked the helmet and head off. Carmichael is very quick for a man 6'8 and 2 1/4.
Phil Tabor and Gary Jeter combined to make the stop for the Giants. Kansas City still leads Oakland, but a touchdown for the Raiders.
Jimmy Plunkett, a 1 yard pass to Jensen.
There's Montgomery behind Peoples, breaking a couple of tackles. And about 8 for Wildert Montgomery. Gary Jeter on the tackle. Watch it from behind the quarterback.
We've talked about the size of a Peyton or Montgomery. That's just about right right now. That's the prototype. 5'10" or 11", 205 pounds, and strong as a mule. From the eye, they are extremely, extremely hard to cut down.
It'll be second and 2 yards. Jaworski is 5 out of 6 throwing for 68 yards. Leroy Harris straight ahead, perhaps enough for a first down, very nearly. Phil Tabor from Oklahoma State, the rookie, made the tackle.
Keep in mind, by the way, that the Eagles jumped off and hid in this first game against the Giants, had a big second period, and then only got off 21 plays in the second half and barely won the football game. Vermeil is not going to take that chance today. Get all you can get now and stay with them for 4 quarters.
They led 23-3 at one point. Wound up winning that first game the opening day, 23-17. It is an Eagle first down.
And intercepted a ball on the Eagle 1 or 2 yard line by young Wilson, or Pasarczyk might have pulled that game out for the Giants.
Seattle 10, Denver 3 in the second quarter. Jim Zorn and company still looking good. First down, Philadelphia at their own 45. They lead 7-6 with 9:05 left to play in the second quarter. Jaworski shifts his backs around. They go back into the die. It will be Montgomery again. Brad Van Pelt, as Montgomery tried to come outside, led the defense.
You can see all of the offensive linemen for the Eagles looking like, did we do something wrong, including Leroy Harris, the fullback. I think Wilbert was supposed to duck it back inside that time, and they were all checking like, maybe we didn't get the play right. This is sometimes when a back decides, I can maybe break it outside. He should have probably stayed inside. But the Giants were fighting their way over in that hole in pretty good shape. He didn't have anywhere to go.
So it'll be 2nd and 9 for Philadelphia. Calvin Miller now playing in the Giant defensive unit. Number 76. And Jaworski throws complete to Charlie Smith.
Jaworski took a heck of a shot, but this is one of the best throws he's made. A very deep sidelines. Watch Tabor now come through and give him a shot after he's unloaded and his man was open. Telling you, when his hot receiver is there, he delivers. That's airmail.
Calvin Miller and George Martin were the defensive men who put the pressure on Jaworski, but he stood in there. Gloves on each hand for Charlie Smith. Pitch back to Montgomery. Montgomery has a little room and gets about 5. Brian Kelly on the stop. Here's Tony Franklin. Well, that's Tony Franklin's foot.
You know, he said he even kicked in Arkansas one day when it was about 12 degrees. So I guess if you can kick in the land of the Razorbacks at that degree, you can kick anywhere, huh?
Joe Pisarcik looking on, number 9, who had started the first 3 games at quarterback and had won the starting job during preseason. But the tremendous beating that he had taken in the first 3 games took its toll finally. And Ray Perkins decided to give him a rest.
Had about 5 injuries listed, you know.
Yes. Second down, Eagles. Long count. And Montgomery gets the call again. Hangs down inside the yardsticks for another Philadelphia first down before Brad Van Pelt makes the tackle.
Now, Wilbert probably goes 198 or 200. It's hard to tell once they get into the season. But that time, he hit Lloyd a shot. The linebacker's got to go 240. And he delivers more than he accepts. Now, from behind the Eagle offense, watch this. Watch 31. Of course, the linebacker has to take you on your grounds, not his. But that's a good shot by a little back.
Montgomery, 9 carries, 39 yards. Seattle, 17. Denver, 3. Dornick has scored again. Jaworski to Carmichael. And Harrell barrels over Ray Rhodes on the other side of the field, and that should be enough for another Philadelphia first down. What an awesome receiver is Harrell Carmichael, 6'8".
Pretty smart little move he made that time. He acted like he was going to go out of bounds, and then all of a sudden he's trying to get to the sidelines. Again, watch. A quick out by a 6'8 receiver who is hot, and he had solo coverage and knew it.
He almost broke that.
He's learned to run patterns, and obviously he's learned very well. He's probably the most feared receiver in football.
Just outside the 10. Eagle first down. Jaworski, 6 out of 7. Sets his two backs again in the I formation with Montgomery B. And Montgomery will carry behind the block of Harris. And it was a good block, but a good defensive play by Brian Kelly shut it off.
Good thing Kelly was really hustling, which he always does. Leroy Harris, the fullback, buried the cornerback.
Two-yard pickup will make it 2nd and 8.
This is the fullback to the left there that Vermeil picked up from Miami. He was unhappy, did a good job, and that's simply a good play by 55.
That was Beasley Reese that he was blocking on. I said it was Ray Rhodes. Jaworski, 7 out of 8 for 100 yards. He may try again right here. He gives Montgomery, and Montgomery is wrapped up as soon as he gets the ball by Phil Tabor, the rookie from Oklahoma State.
Watch the left part of the screen. The center was supposed to block to the offside and cut off the young tackle. Again, that is what youth provides. Watch to the right of your screen. You'll see number 80 just beat the block by Morris, who's a heck of a good center. I guess linemen sit up at night just dreaming about getting their hands on the back before he gets underway.
One of the most difficult things to learn, I think, about offensive blocking is you don't block where they are, you block where they're going to be, if you can.
And a rookie, you might never know where he's going to be for a while.
So it'll be 3rd down, Philadelphia, and now Jaworski does have to, call a timeout, and does. 4 minutes, 10 seconds left to play in the first half. The Eagles lead 7-6 at the moment, but they're knocking at the door at the moment. That's the first down marker, so it's conceivable that the Eagles could make a first down without scoring on 3rd and 11 situation. I've been saying that Phil Tabor is from Oklahoma State. That's incorrect. He's from Oklahoma.
Oklahoma U. Now you got to get Harrell Carmichael doubled up. At least the Eagles will probably anticipate that. He likes to catch near that end zone line.
And I would imagine that's exactly what they'll do. Van Pelt goes out in front of Carmichael at the moment, trying to get him some trouble getting off the line of scrimmage. And Jaworski might just look in the other direction because of that double out there. He does. Keith Trepley, tight end, touchdown Eagles.
That's Trepley's first touchdown of the year. Pat, he seems to play the best in tough games against Dallas, against perhaps the Pittsburghs like next week. Good call here. Again, he had Fitzke and Charlie Homeboy Smith to the right. Carmichael doubled to the left, and only one person left, and that, of course, was, what, Ernie Jones there?
And again, the effectiveness and the result of a Carmichael. That's why Van Pelt is out there, to stop him. There's the double coverage on him, but that frees Trepley. Tony Franklin with his bare foot makes it 14-6 Eagles with 4 minutes, 6 seconds left to play in the first half. Philadelphia 14-6 over the Giants at the Meadowlands. Tony Franklin set to kick off tonight on CBS, 60 Minutes. Featuring a very candid interview with Johnny Carson.
Johnny Carson, that will be interesting.
Archie Bunker's place, Alice Jefferson's, and Trapper John, M.D. That's Billy Taylor, I believe, Beasley Reese, who returns it from the far side of the field. The Eagles scoring drive, 11 plays. They went 77 yards, and it was a good-looking drive.
Jaworski, 8 of 9 now for 111 yards and two touchdown passes. And the Giants might be in a little trouble. They got to make a ripple now and get on the scoreboard. The Eagles look like they know what they can and cannot do, and Giants have to change that.
Randy Dean, the Giant quarterback. The Giants have also changed their running backs. Dean tried to hand off to Billy Taylor.
Boy.
Didn't make a connection, and he had to keep it himself.
He's got to work on this part of his game. That's Bobby Lane's old fear. If you didn't make the handoff, you had to run with it by accident.
How about the Redskins? 17-7 over St. Louis.
St. Louis, not the only guy that got on the board was Theotis Brown, a one-yard plunge, so they must have handled O.J. Anderson a little bit anyway.
Second and 7 for the Giants. With 3 minutes and 20 seconds left in the first half, the Eagles lead it 14-6. Moorhead off to the left side for one or two, perhaps. A little scuffle going on between Gus Coppins and Carl Hairston at the end of that play.
Coppins have been doing a pretty good job on Carl Hairston, and most defensive people have that mentality. Don't touch me, don't block me either, because they try to intimidate the offense. I think Harrison was just trying to get a pretty good block off him. Coppins has been doing a pretty decent job today.
Third and 4 situation now. Light Scales and Johnny Perkins both go wide to the right. For the Giants, the tight end Al Dixon is tight left. Dean sends both backs out, throws wide to the right. It's for Dwight Scales, almost picked off by Bobby Howard. And he had 6.
Well, that time, Simmons, the offensive guard, watch him pick up the blitzer, LeMaster. They do a good job on that. This ball is just flat thrown end over end. Howard was playing the out and really should have had possession of that. He was in better position than the receiver.
Bobby Howard played 13 years as a cornerback. That's a tough assignment. Jennings a little bit off the side of his foot. Wally Henry comes up the field and let it bounce. Now he feels it and starts upfield, and Henry almost broke it. He knew he had a chance, and he's disgusted that he didn't. Emory Moorhead finally made the tackle on Wally Henry. And look at the disgust on his face. He almost was gone. 14-6, Philadelphia lead. The sellout is sort of standard in this ballpark, Giants Stadium. Pat Summerall with Tom Brookshier watching the Eagles against the Giants. And Philadelphia leads 14-6 at the moment. The ball is loose. Beasley Reese picked it up but almost broke it. But I think they're going to bring the whole thing back.
I think that's a one. This is a one play that does age coaches before their time. The fumble, because it can be advanced. And I believe the Giants are going to be given possession of this football.
They are.
Look at that play by Krepler. Oh, otherwise it's at least 6.
I believe it was Gary Jeter who knocked the ball loose. And Randy Dean checks back in.
Two turnovers, huh?
Sooner than he expected. The Giants have gotten 2 fumbles by the Eagles. First one led to a field goal. See what happens to this one. First and 10. Line of scrimmage just inside the Eagles 40. Ernest Gray started in motion. And we'll have the flanker around. And Ernest Gray, who has the good speed, goes inside the 30. Bernard Wilson, the tackler for Philadelphia.
Real good block on the outside by Turner. Watch this block now on the double reverse as Robinson, the linebacker, comes up on the right side. Good block right there. Hello there.
Two minutes to play in the first half. Philadelphia 14, the Giants 6.
Young Dean is 35 yards rushing and 2 for 8 for 17 yards passing, but no sacks. The Giants came in with at least 17 against S. Joe Pisarcik. He'll tell you how many. He's got a mark for every one of them.
That's why he's resting. The Eagles in a huddle. Must be checking on, I'm sorry, the officials. The Eagles were just in a defensive huddle.
They're saying, how about Baked Alaska for dessert?
And how many timeouts do we have?
That's right.
Final score. Somewhat of a shocker. Kansas City 35, Oakland 7.
Morgado with a 3-yard touchdown run, the last scoring shot for the Chiefs.
Look very serious about things here.
Good opportunity for the Giants, though. They take advantage of the second fumble. But you don't get fumbles by accident. You get that by hard work on defense. There's old Marion Campbell to the left there, my old teammate. Vermeil said he was worth a number one draft choice to get him to help his defense.
The Swamp Fox.
The old Fox. His defense is right now is being tested a little bit.
New Orleans 13, San Francisco 7. Our second quarter score. Right here we have 2 minutes to go before the half. At the Eagle 29, the Giant offensive unit will operate. Fake is to Taylor. The throw is down the middle for Al Dixon. And it's picked off by the Eagles' Bobby Howard. Back in the end zone, they'll bring it back to the 20. Looked like Dixon might have been open for just a second.
Well,
the pressure.
You mentioned Howard now as being the old veteran. He might have laid off. Here's Gravel battling with Humphrey and just getting him in line with the quarterback. But Claude got there a little late, but there was no flag. And Howard, meanwhile, down the field from a different angle. It's a semi-row left. I think young Dean thought he was open, and Howard might have wanted that. Let's see how he lays off and makes the play. Oh, that's a good interception.
So Jaworski and the Philadelphia offensive unit come back into action after an interception by Bobby Howard. San Francisco has taken the lead over New Orleans 14-13. Jaworski gets to Montgomery. And Montgomery comes out for an Eagle first down outside the 30.
Steve DeBerg, the San Francisco quarterback, a 25-yard pass to Solomon. Here's Tabor against Perot now, the guard. Ooh, good lead block there by Leroy Harris, the fullback. Wilbert's always under the people that are trying to tackle him, isn't he?
12-yard pickup for number 31. 12 carries, 58 yards for him. Minute 56 left to play in the first half, an Eagle timeout.
Wilbert's the kind of runner that has the defense always feeling their ribs and the hips. There's Howard. First interception of the year, a very large one. Look at there.
He at one time had the responsibility of covering the Giants coach, Ray Perkins, when he was still an active player.
Perkins' problem was he never had any good quarterbacks thrown to him.
Unitas and who else?
Stabler, Namath. There couldn't be a tougher job in the world, though, than coaching in the National Football League. It's no longer a 6 months a year profession. It's 12.
And long days. At the half, we'll update you. At least Brent and Irv and Jane will. Back in our New York studio on what's happened around the league today. There have been some surprising scores. And some big scores. Chuck Bednarik. Great Eagle name of the past.
He's got a clipboard down there. I don't know what he's got written on it, but he has a big clipboard down there.
He picked me up before the game. I mean bodily. Like I weighed about 50 pounds. He looks like he can still play. And wants to, I think.
That's it.
The flag goes down, and so does Jaworski in the grasp of Phil Tabor, number 80.
That time, Jeter and Stan Walters, the big offensive tackle, are really having words. And watch the left part of your screen and see if you can pick it up. Again, you're allowed to stick those hands out in a fist and keep pushing with them. I think the Eagles are going to get caught for holding on hard this time, though. Good rush by the Giants.
Phil Tabor, number 80. 4-yard loss by Jaworski. First sack for the Giants. That one by the rookie.
11 times that Jaworski's been down this season. That's a pretty high total when you think about it. Be very careful with those QBs.
Here it is.
Personal foul. Unnecessary roughness. Number 62. Offense. Decline.
That's young Petey Perot, the offensive left guard. They tell me he got in the New Orleans game and in two plays had a fight started down there, so.
62.
Rather aggressive young player.
You tell me he weighed 305 pounds at one time?
Northwest Louisiana, now he's trimmed down to 260, but he's just bushy-tailed, I suppose.
It'll be second down, Philadelphia. As Jaworski puts it up. Nope. Montgomery struggles outside the 30 before Dan Lloyd takes him down with help from Jeter. Timeout Giants. They have two left. The Eagles have one left.
Giant defense has played extremely well today, considering that they're all pro middle linebackers not playing. Eric Carson's been out the whole game with a virus.
And Mendenhall is not playing either. Jaworski over in conference with his head coach, Dick Vermeil. Don't forget next week, the Vikings against Detroit, the Giants at New Orleans, Washington against Atlanta. Tampa Bay visits Chicago, St. Louis, Los Angeles, and San Francisco goes south to San Diego.
Tampa Bay.
What's that score now? 14-6?
14-6, and Los Angeles' only score has been a young blood interception. Boy, Jaworski having a good year. The rifle. There's some of the defensive brain trust working it out. Hawkins, the coach on the left, talking to Harry Carson, who's not able to play, but has some good ideas, I'm sure.
Looking down at the Eagle bench, and looking at several in green shirts and jackets, concerned about the health of Wilbert Montgomery. Might have been shaken up on that last play. Billy Canfield is in. 3rd and 10. Now Michael has the double coverage up at the top part of your picture, if you can pick it up in a minute. Deep for Charlie Smith, who's nudged out of bounds, and good coverage by number 24, Terry Jackson. There's Montgomery.
That's Otho Davis, the trainer, that's looking at the left hand. Now, Billy Canfield, who went in, is probably a better pass receiver, but nobody does both ways better than Wilbert, at least as far as the Eagles are concerned.
Max Runiger is number 4. He has punted one time so far today for 43 yards. Runiger. Funny looking kick. Out of bounds it goes in front of the Giant bench where they'll take over.
Looked like he had his toe up on that. Once in a while, a kicker gets into a funny stride and doesn't lock the toe down. And that time he kicked it, I believe he had a toe up like one of you field goal types.
He must have, the way the ball behaved. 36 yards. See if we can pick up what you're talking about.
Now watch it. What's the right foot if it really extends like somebody in the Follies? Looked to me like he took a too long a stride, didn't he? He's got the toe up a little bit.
He sure did when he hit the ball.
Sounded like hitting a watermelon in August.
He was watching the rush. Well, he should. It'll be first down Giants. The Eagles lead 14-6. Doug Coter and Emory Moorhead now the setbacks. That's the way they began. Randy Dean still the quarterback. Drops and Carl Harrison takes him down.
And notice the way he did it, Pat. He just kept working. He was actually on his all fours when he makes the tackle. Harrison now has 7.5 sacks. Great effort.
Clock running again now with 1:10 left before the half. And Dean quickly hits Cota across the middle. And he quickly is hit by Reggie Wilkes, the linebacker.
Cota's limping a little bit, too. They hit him right on that thigh. That'll give you a little bruise.
Again, the quick huddle as the clock continues. And Dean goes straight back on 3rd down. Again, Harrison almost got him, and now Dean is going to take off. This time it will not be 1st down yardage, but he does stop the clock with 43 seconds to go. Frank LeMaster again on the tackle, a 6-yard zip by Randy Dean.
Said this young man was what, a national amateur handball champion at one time?
Right. Good at all racket sports.
A lot easier to get a kill shot, though, than have somebody beating on your head that weighs about 262.
Dave Jennings for the Giants, number 13 to punt. Wally Henry deep for Philadelphia. Good high kick chases Henry back inside the 10 to the 8. And he comes out, stays on his feet, struggles to about the 18 or 19 yard line. Emory Moorhead made the tackle with 30 seconds to go in the first half. The Eagles take over. 49 yard kick that time by Jennings.
They tell me that this is the best franchise for season ticket sales in all of football. They have 75,000 plus, and Denver's in second place. But I didn't know it's not the most expensive ticket. It's only about halfway as far as
that's
price.
Correct.
Look at this.
Yeah, that's some sight.
A beautiful afternoon, too.
Coming up next, Brent, Jane and Irv with highlights of what's going on around the league. Billy Campfield and Larry Barnes, I believe. No, it's Harris, still a fullback. That's Campfield. Brad Van Pelt on the tackle. Still no word on how serious or if it is serious to Wilbert Montgomery.
Well, I notice a lot of the Eagles are standing on the sidelines. Very few, in fact, nobody, except a couple of people at the end of the bench on the defensive side, are sitting down. Maybe it's just because they want to get a head start for the dressing room.
There goes Montgomery as the Eagles head into the dressing room, leading 14-6 over the Giants. We still have a half left to play. But don't forget to stick around at halftime of this game for an update on scores around the league. 14-6 Philadelphia.
Back live in New York, I'm Brent Musburger. By far the most exciting Sunday of the season so far. The highest and the lowest, let me show you. It was overtime, Minnesota and Green Bay. The Vikes had the ball. Tommy Kramer pulled out. This one was intended for Ahmad Rashad. He juggled it with one hand, brought it down, broke a tackle, dashed into the end zone, 50 yards. The Vikes win in overtime. Tim Mazzetti with a chance to win for Atlanta against Detroit. Time running out. A 45-yard attempt wide to the right. And last year's hero is this year's GOAT as Atlanta loses and Mazzetti, for the second straight week, fails to connect on a big one. The best game of the day. It was the New York Jets and the Buffalo Bills, and what a wild one. Here is Tommy Newton exploding for Walt Michaels and the Jets. 52 yards on the run, 10-6. Jets in command. Watch Richard Todd now. Go to Mickey Schuler, 27 yards. This play will go down to the 25-yard line. Three plays later, the Jets scored again. It was 17-6 Jets, and it looked easy when Todd hit Wesley Walker with this score, 24-12. But back came Joe Ferguson. Last play of the half, biggest play of the game. It's tipped in the air, and from out of nowhere, Jerry Butler for the score, 24-19. Ferguson and Butler were just warming up. Here it is again, down the near sideline. Butler, 73 yards on this score. It was 26-24. Buffalo, they weren't finished. On the day, Butler caught 10 passes for 255 yards. The record for one game is 303 yards. Three touchdown passes, Ferguson to Butler. Then Richard Todd tried to rally the Jets. He's hit this time. Fumble. Picked up by the defensive lineman. Dashed into the end zone. It was 40-24. Buffalo and Chuck Knox in command. Ferguson on the day. Five touchdown passes. This one to Joe Shipp. Final score was 46-31. And Jane, let's take everybody around the league right now and get them up to date with everything. There's the final score. Detroit 24, Atlanta 23, as Mazzetti missed the field goal. And Rashad in overtime, 27-21. Minnesota wins that one. Pittsburgh rallies against Baltimore 17-13.
Brent, despite numerous injuries, the Steelers still pulled it out on a 28-yard pass from Terry Bradshaw to Benny Cunningham with 5:41 left in the game.
The Jets, that final score against Buffalo is 46-31. And in overtime, it was Houston 30, Cincinnati 27.
Houston's Tony Fritsch won the game with only 38 seconds left in overtime after the Oilers had been trailing 24-0 in the first half.
and in a wild game. San Diego had a chance to win it, and then they missed out. Patriots win 27-21.
New England held off a late San Diego rally as linebacker Steve Nelson intercepted a pass in the end zone, and the Patriots ran out the clock.
Oakland in trouble, losing to Kansas City 35-7.
Kansas City dominated this game, paced by an 88-yard punt return by J.T. Smith and a 70-yard pass with an interception by Gary Barbero.
Washington and Jack Pardee put it together. 17-7 is the final. The Redskins there. Now at the half, of course, the game you're watching, Eagles lead the Giants 14-6. The Bears are ahead of Miami 6-3. That game is in the third period. Also in the second period, in a driving rainstorm in Tampa, it's 21-6 Buccaneers over the Rams right now. New Orleans trailing San Francisco by a point. That game is at the half right now. And in a big one out west, Seattle 20, Denver 10. That game is at the half right now. Irv, you got some highlights, Atlanta, Detroit. I can't believe everything that's going on this afternoon.
A lot of excitement this afternoon. But you know, remember what Monty Clark said before this game started? If we don't beat the Atlanta Falcons, our season is over.
Not over yet, right?
Not over yet, because they hung on to win by 1 point, 24-23 in the Pontiac Superdome. But the game started out on a shaky foot for the Lions as Jeff Komlo fumbles the ball deep in his own territory. Atlanta recovers and Steve Bartkowski goes over on a quarterback sneak. This is in the third quarter. The score is 10-10. Komlo comes back here again, this time a little more confidence. Hits number 89, Luther Blue upfield, which sets up his next scoring opportunity for the Lions. Komlo going upfield again. Guess who? 89, Luther Blue, touchdown. Detroit takes a 17-16 lead. Komlo did a pretty good job. Rookie out of Delaware hands the ball off here to Rick Kane, who goes off his left tackle, and he rambles 26 yards. Touchdown, 24-16 Detroit. But you know the Atlanta Falcons are a never-say-die team. Bartkowski handing the ball off to Haskell Stanbacker. He breaks off his right tackle, goes upfield 55 yards, touchdown, too little, too late. The Lions held on to win 24-23. The St. Louis Cardinals and Washington Redskins, you know when they get together, they're always fireworks. The Redskins had won 5 out of 6 games prior to this weekend's game. Today, make it 6 out of 7. The second offensive play of the game, Hart to O.J. Anderson, pass, fumble, and the ball rolls around to the end zone. Nobody can come up with it, but Don Hover finds a handle for the Washington Redskins. The Redskins take a 7-0 lead in the first quarter. Joe Theismann had a pretty good day working at quarterback today. The Redskins have become an opportunistic team this year. You break a coverage, they'll find the open man. Broken coverage, Buddy Hardeman makes the catch, 35-yard touchdown. Washington takes a 14-0 lead in the first quarter. Jim Hart trying to get his club back on the board, hands off to Theodis Brown. He goes over, touchdown, 14-7 Washington. Late in the game, Cardinals trying to come back. Hart going for a 2-yard pass, can't get it. Lamar Parrish intercepts, and the Washington Redskins hold on to win 17-7.
Herb, updated score right now. Miami has scored again. They're ahead of Chicago now 10-6. And in baseball, 7-4. Montreal a winner over Philadelphia. Pittsburgh downs the Chicago Cubs 6-0. Herman Frank says he will not be back next year. Cincinnati beats Houston 7-1 is the final there. And here's Terry Bradshaw, the Steelers. Under pressure, avoids the rush, gets it off, batted in the air. Nasby Glasgow of the Colts intercepts, and Baltimore went ahead on a field goal. Then it was Bradshaw. Watch his protection. 47 yards. John Stallworth, it was 7-3 after the extra point. Landry of the Colts looking for Roger Carr as the Colts regained the lead 10-7 after the extra point. Bradshaw was injured, then returned. Call for the tight end screen. Fake to the right and sent it back to the left, and there was Benny Cunningham. 17-13. Pittsburgh, a winner against Baltimore. And the NFL Today will continue on CBS after these messages from your local stations.
At the half at Giants Stadium, the Philadelphia Eagles lead the Giants 14-6 on 2 touchdown passes by Ron Jaworski. He's had a good first half.
Yeah, he's 8 of 10 for 111 yards, the 2 TDs. Wasn't intercepted. Very careful, I thought. In fact, it looked to me like the Eagle offense is just about settled into what they think the Giants will do. And I don't think we'll see Sims at all. I think Dean has to throw the football a little bit. They rushed for 80 yards in the first half, which is a pretty good rushing statistic against the Eagles, but they're not putting any points on the board with
it. Tom, you bring up something that has been widely discussed here in New York. The Giants, as you know, went for a first-round draft choice named Phil Sims, who's a quarterback from Moorhead State. Ray Perkins, the coach here, has said repeatedly that Sims is not ready to play. But how do you ever get ready to play if you don't play? You think they ought to put him in?
Well, I think that with the tackle situation the way it is, and there are a lot of jokes around New York about their lack of tackle play, but right now you'd ruin a young quarterback. And Dean is having a little trouble, and he has some experience and is a very fine runner. So maybe if they're looking for the length of a long-term contract for young Sims, it would be fine. But if I was Joe Pisarcik, I'd be a little teed off, like, what am I, chopped chicken liver?
Yeah.
You know, they're going to use me up. And he just can't play. He's got so many injuries, he has to watch young Dean. But I think the Giants have to throw the heck out of the ball in the second half.
Mm-hmm. Well, you know, as you look back over the years, and you and I have been around this game of pro football more than perhaps we'd like to recall, we've
yes.
seen a lot of young quarterbacks like Phil Sims, who does have athletic ability, no question about that. We've seen him ruined by exposing him to the kind of rush that they've been getting.
I think Norm Snead had about 5 years before he ever recovered from being thrown into the breach as a rookie quarterback. I agree with you.
Okay. We have one more half of football to go. It is 14-6. The Philadelphia Eagles come in here with a record of 2-1 against the Giants, who are 0-3. And right now, the Eagles lead it by 8 points. The preceding announcement was brought to you as a public service by the National Football League.
I noticed that Harry Carson, we're told from people in the truck, that Harry Carson's going to go down under this kickoff. I wonder if he's decided that he wants to place the middle linebacker in the second half. There he is. Man from Grambling. It's about as tough an MLB as there is.
We'll keep track of what he does and see how sick he is on this kickoff.
Sometimes at halftime you get well in a hurry.
Sometimes you have to. And Danilo approaches from the side, and Wally Henry will have a chance with this one from the 7. Here he comes with a good wedge in front of him.
Oh.
Henry is hit by Bob Torrey, number 39.
Pretty good run back opportunity and an excellent tackle, or Wally might have gotten to the sidelines. And he is never looking for a short run back, whether the punt or the kickoff. It's all the way. Remember, he ran back the punt against the Rams a year ago, and now he's recovering from that knee surgery. It looks like he's back to his old form.
Ron Jaworski still the Eagle quarterback, and Wilbert Montgomery is back in the game. He had some problems with his left hand in the closing seconds of the first half, but it seems to be now okay. Harris is the other running back with him, number 20, and Montgomery will get the first carry. And will be hit right at the line of scrimmage by the right side of the Giant defense. We should see number 70 there, Gary Jeter and Jeff Weston.
There's 62, Petey Perreault, the rookie, and he is a big one, working against Tabor, also a rookie. Tell you that Tabor's going to be a good one. Remember now, the Giants are now looking and reading on their defensive side.
Philadelphia 10 first downs in the first half, 71 yards rushing.
Pretty good defense by the Giants at 71 yards rushing. It's not too much.
1 yard pickup by Montgomery makes it 2nd and 9. Jaworski straight back, chased by Tabor and taken down by Phil Tabor.
That time, Perreault just let him go too soon.
And Jaworski is shaking a bit.
He didn't even see it coming. There was a screen to the right side. Now watch number 62. Set up, blocked. Now let him go too early, see? He goes back outside. But Tabor's got a lot of things going for him, including a very quick burst. Watch the left part of your screen. He's supposed to hit and hold it a little bit longer than that, and then go set up and make his block. That's too fast for even a fast screen.
16-yard loss on that sack by Tabor makes it 3rd and 24. Carmichael split out wide to the right. Charlie Smith to the left. A little sprint out. And Jaworski says, wait a minute. Might have taken too much time.
Second sack by Jaworski. Remember, he did have that fracture of the finger. He's been playing very well, but Vermeil likes to sort of keep Ron under control, call the plays, let him execute. Giants come out in this third quarter, looks like they're going to wrap people a little bit. That defense is nasty.
Montgomery comes over to the sideline.
Delay of game, number 7, offense.
Called against Jaworski for not getting things underway quickly enough.
You know what he's saying about that right now, don't you?
Third and about 27 for the Eagles. They lead 14-6. Pat Summerall with Tom Brookshier at Giant Stadium. Jaworski has hit 8 out of 10. He gives to Montgomery. And Montgomery is stopped by Brad Van Pelt, and the Eagles will have to punt.
And now this shows the Giants have decided to play hard-nosed defense. And young Runniker has got a punt against a team that blocked that kick in that first game of the season. Here he is.
Runniker is number 4.
From South Carolina.
Deep for the Giants, number 34 is Tony Green. They put a little pressure on him, but he got it away, and Green sees it bounce out of bounds. John Shira was the closest Eagle, number 21. On an absolutely perfect day in the New York area, 39-yard kick, not a cloud anywhere. 60 minutes immediately following the game, Johnny Carson talks, they say, more frankly than he ever has. Mike Wallace profiles the king of late-night television tonight on 60 Minutes.
60 Minutes is always superb, huh?
And you'll see the whole thing. That's Emory Moorhead being bent backwards by Jerry Robinson, the linebacker.
Watch Carl Harrison make the play, Pat. Robinson did get in on it, but watch the defensive end fight, finally drop down, and the blocker on one arm and the ball carrier on the other.
He might have struggled for a couple. Carl Harrison having an excellent year. 2nd and 8 will make it. Eagles in that three-man front. Giants with Randy Dean still at quarterback. Again, Carl Harrison. Charlie Johnson, number 65 for the Eagles, the nose guard.
From Maryland Eastern Shore, 7th-round draft choice, too small at 245. Not even that weight till his senior year in college. And the thing is, he always plays like he's getting ready to be axed, and that's a pretty good incentive.
He's up to about 260 now.
Boy, he's quick, too. Stays low.
And now we'll look at a four-man rush from the Eagles. And scrambling Randy Dean, the Giants quarterback. And he might have to do just that. Flag goes down as perhaps he took too much time.
The Eagles had their four-man rushing team in.
Illegal procedure called against the Giants by referee Jerry Seaman.
Woody Peoples.
Third quarter, Miami 17, Chicago 6 is Larry Zonka. Ball start, has just scored for the Dolphins.
71, offense.
It'll be 3rd and 14.
Gordon Gravel moved just a little bit, prematurely.
Quarterback draw and a bland run this time by Dean, and again the body slam by Carl Hairston. And a chorus of boo starts to rise from this capacity crowd. Carl Hairston, what a series he had.
This looks like it's a play that's been called, quarterback draw. Watch how quickly they drop back. You can see that Turner's trying to block Hairston. He wasn't fooled a bit. There's a better defensive lineman than number 78 around. I don't know if I've seen him this year.
Dave Jennings back to punt for the Giants. Today, 39.7 yard average. That one wind in the direction of Wally Henry again. Henry breaks through a couple of blue shirts and then goes down after he gets 5 more. In the grasp of the snapper, Keith Eck. Dick Vermeil in conversation with his quarterback, Ron Jaworski. We have 10 minutes, 55 seconds left to play third quarter. Eagles lead, 14-6. And look at that score, 21-6 in Tampa Bay.
Another touchdown pass.
From Doug Williams to Jimmy Giles. He's the tight end they got in the trade that sent Earl Campbell to Houston. Took a while, but it looks like it's worked out. Here is for Charlie Smith, overthrown from Jaworski. Again, the pressure on Jaworski was good. Ray Rhodes and Ernie Jones back deep for the Giants.
Ernie made good coverage, the safety man downfield, but that ball was not quite catchable, but well thrown. Heading for number 85 there, straight up, again anticipating double coverage on the tree, Harold Carmichael. 100 straight games. Carmichael record 105 is a Bramowitz's mark, is that right?
Right. Amazing thing about this, about that record, and we've talked about this before, is the fact that you could play in 100 straight games as a wide receiver.
And not get something tangled up with somebody else's.
Especially if you're 6'8 or 9. Second down, Jaworski again goes straight back. And this time the protection holds. And Heath Trepley, the tight end, makes the reception. Beasley Reese on the coverage.
Thomas Henderson with the Dallas Cowboys, who plays tight ends as well as any linebacker, he thinks Trepley is as good as any of them, including Francis. He will make sure of the catch, nothing too flamboyant. And Sid Gilman, the great offensive strategist that works for Vermeil, has them coming back to catch that ball a lot.
Seattle 27, Denver 10 in the third quarter. Jim Zorn, 13-yard touchdown pass to Sam McCollum. First down Eagles, the pitch is back to Montgomery. And Montgomery had some clear sailing before Ray Rhodes came up and cut him down.
Good thing that Rhodes made the ankle tackle that time. Wilbert already had shifted, downshifted, and was heading out. Looks to me like the Giants, though, have maintained their self-control through all of the problems they've had and the rumors and the jokes. They haven't backed off defensively, have they?
Been pretty solid defensively. But there have been some long weeks of practice around here. Long days. Second and six, Philadelphia. Jaworski looks for Carmichael, throws it in the hands of Brian Kelly. Kelly was just waiting as again the double coverage was out on Harold Carmichael. That's the fifth interception of the year for the Giants, the first this year by Brian Kelly.
I wonder if Jaworski tried to get the ball back. Let's see if he tries to yo-yo it and bring it back when he sees there's somebody sitting there. Can't believe he threw that. He may be saying that. I can't believe I did that. Intended for no one except really 55. He was in the best position.
And the return of 14 yards by Brian Kelly.
Trying to get it to Wilbert Montgomery.
Here is Doug Coter. And again, Carl Harrison is one of the tacklers, along with Charlie Johnson, the nose tackle.
Crowd wants some sprint out and some passing from young Dean, who has not been too successful throwing the football. He's 3 for 10 for 21 yards.
4-yard pickup by Doug Coter makes it second and six, and Randy Dean is going to hear some boos if their excitement doesn't generate. And the offense doesn't. Here is Doug Coter around to the right side, and Coter has a Giant first down. Again, number 78, Carl Harrison, with help from Terry Totolo on the tackle. 8 yards for Coter.
JT Turner gets out in front in good shape. Keep watching the left. 68 does a good job. With a missed tackle by Wilkes again on the left side. I don't think he's missed one tackle from the right linebacking spot the whole 3 games prior to this.
The day for Coter hasn't been bad. 12 for 52. And again, there seems to be a necessity for a Giant timeout. And Randy Dean heads over to talk with Ray Perkins. Philadelphia 14-6. The old on the left, the new on the right, and the present in the middle.
Looks like the young man to the right, Sibs, is like the young guy in class.
Don't forget Monday night on CBS, The White Shadow, MASH, WKRP in Cincinnati, followed by Lou Grant. An all-pro line up there. First down Giants. Doug Coter gets the carry, and again he's wrapped up by Carl Harrison.
That couldn't have been the play sent in by the bench.
Can't believe they had a called timeout for that.
And I can't believe it. What a run at number 78. He's almost made every tackle of the second half. Would they go to a three-receiver offense, perhaps, and put maybe Dixon back in there?
Joe Danilo over on the sideline, starting to loosen up. It'll be second and nine at the 24 of Philadelphia for the Giants. Toter struggles into the middle, and again the booze after the tackle by Charlie Johnson. New Orleans leading San Francisco 20-14.
Archie Manning, a short TD pass of 3 yards to Hardy. Looks like New Orleans has finally gotten on top of Frisco, huh? Pisarcik is able to just barely able to hold the clipboard. He has really been banged around.
Talking to Pat Hoxson. Third and seven. Ernest Gray in motion behind Randy Dean, and Dean with the pressure put on by Humphrey. Dean looking for someplace to go and firing deep into the end zone. And incomplete. Ernest Gray leaped. Couldn't hang on.
That's the young draft choice that runs that 4-4-40. The only problem is that sometimes they say he gets open and drops the ball. A great bit of footwork here by the Giant quarterback. Young Dean really does it and airs it. Well, that's a great effort. Just didn't hang on.
And Danilo enters with Randy Dean holding for a 40-yard field goal attempt. It's 14-6, the Eagles lead. Don't forget that Dean's the quarterback. Line drive goes low. No good.
That looked like a corner kick.
Danilo trots off with the score just like it was before he entered. Eagles up by 8. 6:38 left in the third quarter. Eagle ball at their own 23-yard line. First and 10.
That's the Danilo field goal. Might have been blocked, but it looked awfully low coming off, wasn't it, Pat?
Never really got airborne. Here's Montgomery looking for some place to go and finds a little running room. Brad Van Pelt took him down, number 10. Wade Key is a missing member of that Eagle offensive line as you look at Seattle overwhelming Denver 34-10.
That's that Sherman Smith, a one-yard touchdown run. Wade Key, number 72, is going to be operated on for a pulled groin muscle. Gives the young rookie for the Eagles a chance, as you see the young rookie for the Giants over there talking to the now veteran quarterback.
Second and four, Montgomery, 17 carries, 73 yards. 18 carries.
Ooh.
For about 75 yards now. Hit hard by Phil Tabor.
Keep in mind that the Giants lost Troy Archer. We all lost Troy Archer, right? But he was a great football player and a number one choice, along with Tabor and Jeter, the number one draft from USC. The makings of a real fine defensive unit. Obviously, that's not the important loss of a person like Troy Archer, but it explains some of the problems.
And again, they're playing without their middle linebacker, Harry Carson. First down, Philadelphia. And without John Mendenhall in the middle as well. Still Tabor and Weston are filling in. Miami still leading Chicago 17-9 now.
It's Bob Thomas' 37-yard field goal. That's two 37-yarders for the man from Notre Dame. Montgomery with 77 yards on 17 rushes. But it hasn't been easy for him.
First down situation for Philadelphia now. Ball at their own 33. Motion is Smith. And Jaworski throws out to the other side. The handle can't be found by Wally Henry. They were trying to set up a flanker screen. Except for the ball, it might have worked.
The tackle was already out there, Stan Walters. The ball looked like it might have been almost a lateral. Had it stayed in bounds, the Giants might have been scrambling for it.
Giant bench with Doug Van Horn, a veteran guard from Ohio State, out of action today, along with several other people. And Joe Pisarcik, one of those several other people, too. Second and 10, Philadelphia.
They all want to play, too, Pat. It's amazing. They really wanted to play today.
Montgomery lines up as the lone setback by himself, and now Harris comes back with him. See if he sends him out. Montgomery comes out, and Harris goes out the other way. The fire is down the middle for Kepler. What a catch by Keith Kepler. On his side, he slid into that one, and he's hurt.
Looked like somebody's cleats came across the tight end side as he went down. You can't find concentration like that. Perhaps in pro golf, something like that. But watch the eyes and the hands of the tight end number 84, and all he's thinking is catching it. He's not worrying about the other part of it, and this is rough.
Boy, just about thrown anywhere else, that ball would have been knocked down. Here's the heat on Ron Jaworski. An amazing catch by Keith Prepway.
Good.
Keith Prepway, who is shaken up, is trotting over to the sideline without assistance, which is always encouraging.
Well, he refuses that. The only way you can get him off the field or not play if he is injured is to take the suit away from him. Incredible competitor.
A refugee from the World Football League.
Charlie Young went to California. Everybody booed in Philadelphia until they saw number 84 play.
John Spagnuolo of Yale is now the Eagle tight end, number 88. Wilbert Montgomery cuts back into the middle and goes down in the grasp of George Martin, number 75. 4.5 minutes left to play third quarter. The Eagles on the move again.
Martin playing extremely well right now over Sizemore. He was the one that rushed Jaworski on that last throw to Prepley, and that time he made a good solid tackle. There's Keith. He had a punctured lung and a collapsed lung a year ago, and like I said, they had to take the uniform away from him. He still wanted to play.
Second and 7. Charlie Smith spread out wide to the right. Carmichael left as Montgomery moves on the draw play and gets another Eagle first down.
Lloyd is playing tough. See number 54. Here's the draw, though, that makes him back out. And now Morris comes through. He gets a pretty good block on him. By that time, the middle linebacker has his hands full, getting rid of a blocker to make the tackle. It's a tough place to be thrown into in a hurry.
They operate from the 26-yard line. Montgomery now 20 carries, 88 yards. First down, Eagles. Is Wilbert Montgomery, who bangs ahead to about the 21 before they stack him up. Keith Prepley with a little headache perhaps at the moment. It looked like he might have gotten kicked in the head.
Accidentally by, I think Ernie Jones was just trying to knock the ball away. Everybody was just playing the ball. Wilbert Montgomery goes to work on Sunday afternoons much like an 8-to-5 fellow in any city. I mean, he doesn't wear a suit, you know, and a tie and all, but he's not too spectacular, but when you add up what he does at the end of the day, he's done a heck of a job.
Seattle 34-17 over Denver. Craig Morton has just thrown a touchdown pass. Phil Sims loosening up his arm over by the Giant bench. Second and 5, make it. It is Harris struggling down to about the 17 or 16 with Dan Lloyd around his legs, knocking him down.
Has Sims been interviewed, the number one draft for the Giants? Has anybody talked to him? Does he talk to the press?
Yes.
Well, some of the Giants don't.
Oh, he'll talk.
He's talking now to Joe Pisarcik, the other quarterback. Oh, there it is, off the other leg.
Talking to Pisarcik at the moment.
Good looking young athlete, though, huh?
Yeah, 6'3", about 215. Into the game at middle linebacker comes Harry Carson. And out goes Ernie Jones, so they've got four linebackers now as Jaworski ducks his head and goes for the first down. It looks like he has it. He looks like he's about 14.
Had a couple of good quarters against the Steelers, though, in preseason play. They were extremely impressed with him, the Steeler linebackers, a couple that I talked to.
No question about physical ability. He's got that.
Gonna have to put a computer inside his lobotomy.
All right.
It's a lot to learn, though, isn't there?
In a hurry in a situation like this. First down, Philadelphia. Ball at the Giants 16 now. The Eagles lead it 14-6. Outside to Carmichael, who ducks around one tackler. Tries to get around some more, gets to the 15. Got a yard as Brad Van Pelt was the first man there. Phil Tabor came out in pursuit of
Perkins has got to, he's got to be happy, though, Pat, the way that bunch that time came over in pursuit. After one of the losses early in the year, he didn't think some of the Giants wanted to play. And there's one thing this defense has proven to him, by golly, they'll keep hitting. And that time they had six people over after Big Harold.
Well, of course, last Monday night was disaster against the Redskins. The week before that was sort of a two-half game against the Cardinals, and then the first time against the Eagles. It hasn't been a good debut for Perkins. He gives to Montgomery. Does Jaworski again, straight ahead. Ernie Jones, the safety man, made the tackle. Montgomery got down near the 10. 6-yard pickup for Wilbert.
But it's been mostly offensive Giant problems. Johnny Unitas, who should know something about it, says that if you don't have a great fullback and great tackles, you can't run the football anymore in the National Football League with these defenses.
The word on Keith Krepfle from the Eagle bench is that he has a slight concussion, and it's very unlikely that he will return. 16 seconds left to play in the third quarter.
That's the Eagles' number one draft, Jerry Robinson, the All-American from UCLA. And his counterpart with the New York Giants.
Their first round draft choice.
Did you play as a rookie?
Yes.
I can't remember when I was a rookie. I think I played too, but so long ago.
Miami 24-9 over the Bears now. The Dolphins trying to remain unbeaten.
You think it was a little bit more simple a game when we played?
Not as many people playing.
Or watching.
That's very true.
The focus right now is what makes it so tough, I think.
Phil Sims. Next week on CBS, the Vikings, the Lions, the Giants against the Saints, the Superdome. Washington, surprising some people, at Atlanta. Tampa Bay, Chicago, surprising a lot of people is Tampa Bay. St. Louis visits Los Angeles and San Francisco against San Diego.
San Francisco plays pretty good football. You know that Walsh is some coach. He's gotten together a pretty good ball club.
Jaworski over on the sideline looking back in the direction of Dick Vermeil. Out comes Harris. In goes Camfield.
Camfield, good pass receiver. Young man out of Kansas.
It'll be a third down and 5 situation. Jaworski looking from the Giant 11-yard line. He will begin this operation. Throws it out of bounds.
Great play, though, because a few years ago, Ron would have thrown that, perhaps trying to make that completion. That time he says, oh, forget it. Let's call in the kid from the Texas Aggies and get 3.
Camfield coming out, but Tony Franklin on the field with that one bare foot.
That sexy foot.
He does not anticipate any problems in the cold weather.
He's 6 for 6. He's got a gambler's heart.
And is a good athlete in addition to being a fine kicker. And booms it high and true. 28-yard field goal by Tony Franklin that went up higher than the goalpost.
How far did the one in the Sun Bowl on CBS that we saw him do 3 years ago, Pat, or 4 years ago? Was that?
I believe it was 62 yards.
62 or 64?
Something in the 60s. And I remember kicking off. He kicked it all the way out of the end zone and into the stands behind.
Somebody in Juarez caught it, I remember one time.
And threw it back. Seven seconds left to play in the third quarter. Franklin waits for the tee to come in. He used a 2-inch tee in college to kick his field goals. Now, of course, in the pros, he's got to kick off the ground, and he says he really had no problem.
Well, you get a choice, I guess, don't you, in the pros, of whether you want to or not on the kickoff?
On the kickoff, yeah. You can use a tee, but extra points from field goals, you can't, of course.
I don't know if we recommend all young kickers going ahead and trying it with a bare foot.
I don't recommend it.
You just say get the good old square toe on, right?
Yeah. So Tony Green will be the man most likely to handle this kickoff. And it is. Green is cut down on the far side of the field by Louis Giamona. 18-yard return, number 33. Good job on the special teams. Again, as Randy Dean. That's the end of the third quarter with the score, the Eagles 17, the Giants 6. And we now pause for a word from your local station.
Where's everybody?
Well, I put a shotgun in so fast. You know that? I put a shotgun in so fast on this team.
Mm-hmm.
Coder's a great little receiver coming out of there.
The Eagles scoring drive, 6 plays, 31 yards. The field goal by Tony Franklin makes it 17-6. And Randy Dean still the quarterback. Dean fakes, throws Robinson, incomplete. Bobby Howard, the veteran cornerback on the coverage.
I'm wondering if Coach Perkins will maybe come with a shotgun offense to help out the young quarterback. If Randy Dean's got to play him for a while, let him sit back there and take that snap and see where the rush comes from for a while.
New Orleans now 27-14 over San Francisco. Brian Kelly in discussion with Brad Van Pelt. Penalty on that last play, it appears.
Looks a little uncertain throwing the football, you know.
He
sets up pretty well. Let's listen here.
Holding number 56, defense.
Jerry Robinson, the guilty Eagle linebacker. It'll be first and 10 after that defensive holding penalty. 14:55 left to play. The Giants Stadium, Randy Dean. Under pressure from Claude Humphrey, but sets up a screen and a good one. Doug Coder out of bounds at about the 46-yard line. First down, Giants. Terry Totolo pushed him out.
Great play by young Dean. Watch him take the rush, and Humphrey really puts it on. And now Reggie Wilkes, the linebacker, gets caught inside. And now the quick flip, pretty well handled by the young quarterback. You can see that 51 hasn't shown up. It'll be a while before... There he is. 51's coming in his wake.
Another view of that screen pass. Well executed.
Coder, the veteran of Kentucky, plays it well. Good action.
And a 20-yard game. As Randy Dean again uses Coder. This time with not as much success. He's out for about a couple. John Shara is the first man to hit him, number 21. Signals coming in from the Giant coaching staff on the sideline.
You imagine Charlie Connery looking to the sidelines and getting a play called?
No.
Can you imagine him seeing the sidelines?
He might ask somebody in the huddle to call it for him. Second down. They need 7. And Coder is hit right in the middle of the line by Charlie Johnson. As the crowd a little impatient with the play selection.
See how Harrison is off that line of scrimmage, so he has a little more room to take the block. A good one by Gravel.
Double team by Shirk and Gravel, and a stalemate like that is pretty good.
Who would have had nerve enough to call a play for Norm Van Brocklin, even when he was a coach?
Seattle 34-31 now over Denver as Craig Morton has thrown 3 touchdown passes, leading that Denver comeback. Dean fires to Coder. Flag is down. Scrambling down close to the 30.
Clark, the defensive lineman, claims it's on him. The pass protection was almost too good that time for Dean.
19-yard pickup is going to be called back because of holding.
Straight drop back. Again, if you've got a sprint out quarterback, Ball is delivered.
It's going to be on Tom Neville, I'm sure.
Holding number 74.
Yep.
Offense.
You've got those defensive ends. They know you got to catch up. They're down by 11 points. And Marion Campbell turns the rush loose. It's tough to block them.
Giants have been penalized six times, lost 40 yards because of it. The Eagles four times, 28 yards. Third down, 14. 17-6, Philadelphia leads. Here is Randy Dean dropping and sprinting out, being chased. And finally fires in the direction of Gary Shirk, the tight end. Throw a little bit behind him as Dave Jennings comes in. Bernard Wilson, the Eagle defender.
Couple of the chasers, Humphrey and Harrison, thought that the young quarterback had run past the line of scrimmage, but he did not.
Dave Jennings deep. Wally Henry deep for Philadelphia. Jennings number 13. Good kick. Henry looking for some place to go, can't find it. Coverage is good, led by Beasley Reese. 45-yard kick.
He is really clever under that punt. He looked around to see where everybody was coming from as the ball was coming down.
12:57 left to play. Eagles up 17-6. The World Series of Golf next week. Next Saturday at 3:30 p.m. Eastern Time, and Sunday at 4, Firestone Country Club in Akron. Tom Watson, Hubie Green, Lee Trevino, Haler, Andy Bean. $100,000 first prize. Jaworski has a first and 10 and gives to Montgomery. And the Eagle offensive line really fired off the ball that time.
You want to take a look at a big package. New England cut a young fellow named John Spagnuolo. A Yaley, a big rookie. Take a look at him. He's 6'5", 245. And they say he's got a very high IQ. Whether or not he's coachable, we'll find out. No, he really is a good-looking young tight end.
He looked like he got the right assignment.
Montgomery now over 100 yards, 105 on 23 carries.
Eight of which just stand right there. Here's Montgomery with a blocker in front. This time, a good play by Beasley Reese. Oh, he played that well, didn't he?
That one hurts. Wilbert's going to get up slow, and I bet Wilbert Montgomery comes out of the game.
Canfield is headed in already.
Watch the takedown. The toss, tailback in the eye. That's Leroy Harris, the fullback out in front. Brian Kelly gets loose. That does hurt.
They had it pretty well filled on the inside. Look over on the Giants bench. A lot of people looking down. Jim Plack, the offensive center, his head buried in the towel. On third down, Jaworski gives to Harris, and Harris breaks out of the pack. Harris, near the 50. What a second effort. Finally stopped by Beasley Reese. Leroy Harris, a 26-yard pickup.
This is what Vermeil hoped that the fullback he got from Miami would do. Pretty good block on Tabor by Perot, and Morris gets the running back out of there. Harris has lost about 8 pounds since arriving in Philadelphia, and looks like he's going to lose a little more and be some kind of a threat.
Out almost to midfield, just about a half yard shy. He has 6 carries, picked up 41 yards. Giving that clutch first down, and here is Campfield. He stays on his feet. Campfield knocked out of bounds by Ernie Jones, but another good gain for the Eagles.
Sort of a physical culture wacko, but I'll tell you, Campfield is bench presses and works the machinery in the offseason after a pretty good rookie year. And he just is so strong that might explain some of the balance you see him bounce around instead of fall down.
They have entered the fourth quarter at Tampa Bay, and the Bucs still lead 21-6. Second and two here, an 8 yard pickup by Campfield. Larry Barnes now into the backfield for Philadelphia. Number 38, along with Campfield. 37 is Campfield. And Billy breaks into the Giants secondary, and again, Good yardage as Brad Van Pelt has to make the tackle.
Good blocking by Sizemore, the right tackle, and Peoples the right guard. Watch in the top of your screen. This is head-on stuff against an over defense. Peoples just takes the defensive tackle out. We talked about Camfield and his strength. Now you see it.
That face would tell you the score. Ray Perkins concerned. First down, Philadelphia. At the Giant 32. The Eagles already lead 17-6. Trying for more. Jaworski throws outside, intended for Larry Barnes. Larry Barnes, 5'11", 220 from Tennessee State. Jaworski looks over to Vermeil.
Jaworski wasn't too sure where Barnes might be on that. Looked like he was just as happy that there's no circle around it.
Jaworski has thrown two touchdown passes. One to Montgomery of 53 yards. One to tight end Keith Kepfling of 11 yards. Tony Franklin has the rest of the points for the Eagles. Second and 10. Draw play to Camfield is diagnosed rather well.
A Giant defense said this is our get even play, you know.
Calvin Miller, the first man to hit him.
Looked like we had a little safety blitz maybe too, didn't we? Looked like I saw a defensive secondary. Watch the twist up front. Here comes the secondary people in. You only get about three of those, three good ones like that a year. That's tall cotton.
Third and 13. If they don't get the first, we might see Tony Franklin no matter how far out it is. Wally Henry has entered along with Scott Fitzke for the Eagles. Carmichael split wide to the left, out of your picture. Has the single coverage this time. It's thrown in the direction of Carmichael. The railroad's right with him. Is it going to be Franklin? Or is it going to be Runniger?
What would that be, about a 54-yarder if Vermeil would decide to? There's a flag down right now. There's a debate, huh? Carmichael has four for 29.
Holding. Eagles. Would you take it or not? You, of course, are aware, if you're the Giants, of that weapon on the other side of the field and the person of that barefooted kicker. Hard to refuse a major penalty like that, although they'd have another try on third down if they took it.
You got to take the yardage, though, don't you?
I think so.
Holding. Number 88. Offense. Decline.
And Franklin is on. He is 7 out of 7 for the season. This one would be over 50 yards, about a 53-yarder. And he was doing that with a lot of room to spare in the warm-up before the game.
If he should miss, the ball would come back to the line of scrimmage, right?
Which is the 30, just outside the 35. Tony Franklin, soccer style and barefooted. The longest one he's tried.
Ooh.
Wide to the left, but far enough.
Plenty strong enough.
Tony Franklin, the young man from Texas A&M. A very strong rookie place kicker. Think he wanted to make that? Look at Tony Franklin in the insert moments ago.
He made 16 over 50 at Texas Aggies. He's hot.
He's also got a shoe on that foot now. So in case somebody steps on him, it won't hurt that badly. First down Giants. The ball came back, as Tom Brookshier pointed out, to the original line of scrimmage, as Randy Dean fires out to Moorhead. We're about 7 or 8. 9 minutes even left to play, as the Eagles, for the second time this year, would appear to be well on their way to defeat the Giants. They won on opening Sunday, 23-17.
Giants have over 100 yards rushing. Dean has 41 of that. Coder has 61 on 16. Looks to me like a few sprint out patterns for young Dean. He might be all right there.
What is that, a Philadelphia Cowboy boot?
Can't tell what that one is.
I never had anything like that. Brent Coder will have a giant first down. Look at this score, Tommy. Denver 37, Seattle 31 now.
Rob Lytle is back and scored on a one-yard run for Denver. Craig Morton's back too, isn't he?
I'll say.
Three touchdown passes?
Right.
Everybody keeps burying Craig, and he just keeps popping back, doesn't he?
He sits off on one end of the bench by himself and thinks about what might happen if he plays again, and it's usually good. Randy Dean, 6 out of 15 for 55 yards. Derek Coder swings in motion to the left, and Dean comes straight back to Coder. He cuts back in the middle, or tries to, and is in the grasp of Jerry Robinson.
Robinson, of course, playing because John Bunning, the regular linebacker, had a double virus coming out of New Orleans. Must have eaten something down there that didn't quite agree with him. He said it.
A double virus?
A double virus, one on top of the other. Here's Charlie Johnson playing clack. This is nose to nose. Tough duty on that line of scrimmage.
Well, now we're going to New Orleans next week. So you look out for those virus.
We're hard on viruses.
Especially double viruses. On second down, Dean is under pressure. Does get the ball loose. Coverage by number 58, Terry Totolo.
Randy Logan, the safety man, blitzed that time and couldn't get Dean down quite as quickly as he wanted to.
So they flip the down indicator to third down. Ball just in Eagle territory. They're 49. In motion on third, and Dean straight back again, and look out for Hairston. Throw is down the middle and caught by Ernest Gray. That time the Giants' second round draft choice hung on.
Out of Memphis State, Pat, he does run, and he got open, and this time made a very difficult catch. Hairston comes around to the left part of your screen. Doug Dean stayed in there and really squeezed off a good pass. That's a good throw and excellent catch.
Bobby Howard on the coverage. First down Giants at the Eagle 31. Philadelphia leading 17-6. Dean fakes and is going to take off. Randy Dean is swarmed under as the flag goes down on that play. Jerry Robinson again on the tackle, but a penalty marker is down.
That time, Charlie Johnson, the nose guard, came across and couldn't find anybody to hit except Coder, who happened to be faking too well.
Holding against the Eagles.
Some good supping whiskey would feel good right now for the man from Kentucky. He faked pretty well on that naked, didn't he?
Holding, number 51, defense.
Reggie Wilkes, defensive holding. It'll be a first down Giants at the 18. Dean has carried seven times, averaging that 7 yards.
And he's only been sacked twice by a pretty good sacking type team.
6 minutes, 17 seconds left to play. Very few have departed Giants Stadium so far. Dean goes back. And throws for... Oh, just knocked down at the last minute. It pinned it for Ernest Gray. He thought he had it. Cornerback Bobby Howard just got a hand in there.
And a great pattern by Gray. 4-4 speed for the 40, but you've got to catch the football. He runs smoothly enough. Watch this throw. Good pass protection. Good protection. Oh, man, this has TD written all over it.
Howard did not touch it. I thought he got a hand on it, but he didn't. Look at this protection.
All right, watch Gravel, a very celebrated number 71 these days, working on Carl Hairston and really sticking in there.
It'll be second down now. Doug Coder. And Moorhead. Here is Gary Shirk, the tight end. Down near a first down. Randy Dean looking better. 9-yard gain.
And now mixing up his plays and throwing every down. So Perkins decide, what the heck, let's see how many different things we can do. Shirk is the better blocker of the two tight ends, but not supposed to be the best receiver, is he?
No. Third and one. Dean now 9 out of 20 for 84 yards. Gus Coppins checks into the offensive line, and he and Neville are the offensive tackles now as Gravel goes out.
And 5.5 minutes left, a lot of time if a touchdown goes on the board.
Third and one. Doug Coder will try to get the first and does. Frank LeMaster on the tackle along with Claude Humphrey. Watch it develop.
Off the left side, you're right behind the left cornerback, Shara, on this short yardage situation. That will show you another angle of that same play. A very tough yard to get, especially against a good rushing defensive team, and the Eagles are. LeMaster and Humphrey making that tackle.
First and goal now from the 7. Eagles lead 17-6 as Dean fakes the Coder and cuts back for the Giant touchdown.
That is the second rushing touchdown for the New York Giants or the New Jersey Giants this year.
Randy Dean.
It's a naked, good cutback here. Makes Charlie Johnson miss him. Giants did a good job rallying around him on the outside. Good blocks.
8 carries, 57 yards for Dean, and that touchdown. Danilo with Dean holding. Hits it. 17-13. Don't go away.
4.5 minutes left. Here's the fake to Coder. A lot of people took it. Charlie Johnson didn't. Tell you, Dean is a good athlete.
Very quick. And a touchdown by the quarterback. 4.5 minutes left.
Wedge. Looking for a half wedge here, Patrick?
That would be a good play. Look where all the Eagles are. Saw him just a second ago as Danilo is ready to kick with 4:31 left to play. Wally Henry has got to be very lonely back there. And that's exactly what they did. Number 22, Bernard Wilson, made the very intelligent play.
A rookie probably had his heart in his throat. Here's that lineup. It's sort of like a pulled-in infield. And that's this little job by Danilo, a half wedge. Ah, put it away.
Very good play. Tonight on CBS, 60 Minutes, that interview with Johnny Carson, Archie Bunker's place, Alice Jefferson, Trapper John M.D. Look at Gary Jeter encouraging the fan.
Jaworski's got his hands full right now with that offense. He's got to move the football.
In motion comes Smith on first and 10. Jaworski with the long count gets to Montgomery. 2 or 3, not much more. Clock still running now. 4:15 left to play by the time they unstack. George Martin, Brad Van Pelt on the tackle.
Remember, if you're carrying the football, you have to be thinking about not fumbling, which is just about the best time to fumble I can think of.
When you start to try to protect it.
Oh, yeah.
Montgomery has carried 25 times now for 104 yards. He and Leroy Harris are the setbacks for the Eagles. 2nd and 8. Montgomery again. He'll get to about the 36, but not enough for a first down. Brad Van Pelt on the tackle.
Crowd really loves this. The crowd is being turned on by the Giant defense, which is the way they grew up.
The crowd or the defense?
Well, there's been a great tradition playing defensive football. Here's Wilbert, and Van Pelt really sticks it.
Chicago losing to Miami 31. unbeaten. Third and four at Giant Stadium. Pat Summerall with Don Brookshier. Watching Ron Jaworski. Run his offense and he's going to throw. Or going to try to. And finally ducks his head and goes down. The Eagles will have to punt. Calvin Miller led the Giant defensive charge along with Gary Jeter.
Number seven did not want to throw this football at all, much less throw it into some blue jersey. Put it away early, and you can see that Giant defense going crazy.
Runniger has averaged 37 yards on his kicks so far. The Giants put the pressure on. Runniger goes down, and a flag goes down. They're going to be called for running into the kicker.
Automatic first down.
Automatic first down is correct.
The Giants came so close to getting the football. Here's the rookie from South Carolina's punt.
You cannot touch him. It was unintentional, granted, but you can't touch him.
Got to get the ball if you do before you touch him.
Wait a minute. They'll offset.
Unsportsmanlike.
There were two penalties on the play.
There was roughing the punter, but there was something on the Eagles, and I didn't get that signal.
I didn't either. Maybe we'll hear. Welcome those of you who've been watching Miami.
Downfield.
There you are.
Number 51, kicking team. Running into the kicker, number 31, defensive team.
Good call by the official, though. Good call.
Again, those of you who watched Miami defeat Chicago, welcome to Giant Stadium. Pat Summerall with Tom Brookshier. We have just over 2.5 minutes left to play. 17-13. Ooh. The Eagles lead. Tony Green is in too. Tony Green put up his hand, indicating fair catch, and Shira ran into him, and he's hot about something. Maybe you're saying he was blocked into it.
Shira looked like he made some contact, but stumbled. The people be the judge this time. He was making contact with number 25.
25 is Ray Oldham, who was back there with him. And Shira doesn't think he was guilty. 35-yard punt. And the flag went down.
It sure puts the Dean offense back in business if it's going to be called there.
They trail by four, the Giants do. 17-13, here's the walk-off. And Randy Dean will operate from almost dead center field.
Personal foul, fair catch interference, kicking team.
Green had his hand up. He made the fair catch signal plenty of time.
50 yards away from a touchdown. First down, Randy Dean with Doug Coder and Moorhead, the running backs. Protection is good. Moorhead has it. Front of the Eagle bench, breaks away from one tackle, gets out of bounds. Legend Wilkes, the Eagle tackler. But he accomplished what he wanted to after a 5-yard gain.
You mentioned the protection was good. That time, Humphrey and Harrison, the defensive side on your right, run together and fall down. Both of them just disappear and fall on the ground. Look at the blockers, looking for somebody else to help on. And Dean loved it. Good move by Moorhead on the outside.
Ray Perkins, quest of his first victory. Randy Dean, his quarterback, sets him down on second and five. Fourth quarter, New Orleans 30, San Francisco 21, and the Garrow Ukrainian field goal. A lot of noise at Giant Stadium as Randy Dean fires, and the Eagles are saying he intentionally grounded it.
Wow. Defensive noseman Clark ran over Dean, the quarterback, on the rollout. Dean's just now getting back up.
Flag is down downfield. maybe against the Eagles. Yes.
Automatic first down.
Al Dixon checks in place of Gary's shirt. It is a first down.
Illegal contact. Defense.
Illegal check, maybe outside of that 5-yard line of scrimmage rule.
Ball just inside the Eagle 40. First and 10 Giants. That much time left. Dixon, and it's picked off by Shira for Philadelphia. And John Shira, the all-purpose Philadelphia Eagle, comes up with the interception.
There's the young man that ran into Green on the punt return on the fair catch signal. Ball is thrown sort of high and hanging. That's Dixon down the middle, and Shira really wanted this one. You make a big mistake on a Vermeil team, you better make a big play coming back.
And John Shira did just that.
He sure did.
The Eagles take it over. Line of scrimmage will be their own 21 with just over 2 minutes left to play. 17-13, the score. And with that interception now, the loyal Giant crowd starts to depart. Montgomery again. Out of bounds, and that will stop the clock. And we'll have the less than 2 minute warning. Beasley Reese got him out of bounds. The clock has stopped. Both coaches will be notified exactly how much time is left. The Eagles up by 4. Marion Campbell has just conversed with his defensive unit.
He said, if we have to go back in there, don't take any fakes, meaning keep everything in front of you and bang people.
21-6, Tampa Bay still leading the Los Angeles Rams. There will be bedlam in Tampa Bay tonight.
And they go to the Windy City on CBS here next Sunday.
To Chicago. 1:57 left to play. Eagles leading 17-13. That's Summerall with Tom Brookshier. Giant Stadium as Wilbert Montgomery covers up the football. It'll be third down. Ryan Kelly and Gary Jeter led the defense. Timeout situation is that.
And Eagles will sort of slow down everything. Not a lot, not deliberately. By the way, Jeter and Stan Walters have really been at a Mexican standoff in that line of scrimmage. The big offensive left tackle and the right defensive end have really nullified one another. Look who's coming.
Harry Carson. Second appearance he's made so far, and out goes Ernie Jones. So they'll have an extra linebacker. They need about a yard for a first. Jaworski will try to get it, and he's going to be close. Carson led the defensive charge. They'll unstack, they'll stop the clock, and then they'll measure in all likelihood.
Looking at all this defense, especially Carson coming in, I wonder if Berge's in a hospital room somewhere right now, about ready to fall out of it. That first weekend when you're not playing and you've just had surgery is rather difficult indeed.
He had a rather long operation, we heard.
Good operation, but a long one. They wanted to make sure. DeStefano spent 3 hours on the Berge's knee.
A big knee. They got it. Very close, but an Eagle first down on the quarterback sneak by Jaworski, and they ought to be able to run it out now. The Giants have 2 timeouts remaining.
Giants have to get some positive feeling for a young team out of this, as hurt as they are, to play this well. A playoff team, so to speak, from last year, right?
Right. Clock still running. The Eagles and the Giants will be through for the year after this contest is over. And the Eagles, if they run out the clock, would have won them both. Neither one of them easy. Montgomery again. And Wilbert Montgomery outside the 40 near another Eagle first down. Ernie Jones had to make the tackle after a 9-yard pickup.
Did Wilbert put his arms around that ball, both of them around, and protect it?
32 seconds left to play. Eagles 17, the Giants 13, Jaworski 2 touchdown passes. Kurt Montgomery.
Yep, Abilene Christian. I think old Lance Merrill, our stat man, used to block for him, didn't he?
That's right.
Quite a football player.
He really has, as you pointed out a minute ago, sort of stabilized things. Got some clutch yardage, including that last 9-yard run. 32 seconds left to play now. Jaworski just ducks his head and will not get the first down. Robert Stinner.
Big Bob, producer. Big Robert.
Thank you again, Bob. And Sandy Grossman, the director. Boy, they make it easy for us.
Yeah, they just make it exciting for the people at home, too. We appreciate it very much. 60 minutes with Johnny Carson.
Interviewed by Mike Wallace. Uh-oh. Hi, Mom.
Vermeil would hear that. You know what he'd do to that group right there? They'd be running laps all week. Charlie Johnson and Harrison and young Runniger, the punter. See you later.
Phil Sims and Randy Dean over on the Giant bench talking about what's transpired today.
Little spread out series and rollouts. That last touchdown drive we saw run by Dean looked, had all the looks of a real professional job on it.
Mm-hmm. 26 seconds left to play. The ball just outside the Eagle 40. A third down for them. Jaworski brings them out slowly.
You're not going to hand the ball off, obviously, especially in this stadium in particular, right?
If you remember last year, you won't. Now they've got those backs back there just to protect Jaworski, and a flag goes down as somebody in the offensive, in the defensive line, I believe, jumped.
That's Charlie Homeboy Smith they got back in that short punt formation. If they snap that ball back to him, what do you think he'd do?
He'd run in the other direction. You can see the safety.
That'd be some potato to slip back to the guy by mistake, wouldn't it?
Wouldn't it, though? That'll do the first down damage right there. Somebody encroached.
Number 54,
Dan Lloyd.
You know what Siemens' crew has done today, though? He's allowed these two teams to play football. There's been some good contact without the flags flying too often, too frequently.
Eagle bench, a happy spot. Perhaps a little bit nervous a few minutes ago. Harrison, Keith Krepfley, who our information is, suffered a slight concussion earlier after making a spectacular catch. And again, Jaworski just covers it up. That should do it.
Boy, Jaworski's done a great job, too. Looks like they gotten a pretty good performance out of a young rookie left guard, Perot.
Yep. And the Eagles will up their record to 3-1, 1-1. And the Giants would be 0-4. Stay tuned. We'll be back after this word from your local station.